Stay dry, fellas.
Welcome to ESPN's College Football. We are back on campus tonight. The Oregon State Beavers take on the number 3-ranked LSU Tigers. All season ESPN Saturday Night College Football will be broadcast in high definition, presented by Phillips and Best Buy. Well, this is a live shot of Tiger Stadium, and we are just moments away from getting this one started. But in case you just joined us, this is what happened just about an hour ago. It had been hot, it had been sunny, and then, I mean, a monsoon came down. And what was a very dry field that had been protected from the rains yesterday, everybody, including the Golden Girls and their new uniforms, everybody got drenched. And, I mean, we had a heck of a rainstorm. Then it got a little dangerous because it was lightning, and the officials quickly headed to the locker room. They got the band off the field. They sent the kids to the locker room, the football players. And that is how we have been in a holding pattern, which started at about 5 minutes before 5 o'clock. We were very close to kickoff, didn't get there. Now we plan on it. Mike Gottfried, what kind of difference does this make in the football game for both teams, and who does it favor?
Yeah, I don't think much of a difference, Ron. They still have to protect Derek Anderson, the quarterback. Now defensive backs might slip a little bit, so Oregon State may get an advantage from their passing game. LSU does too.
Well, as you can tell, the crowd still ready to whoop it up as head coach Saban brings his team onto the field. And let's take a look and a listen. Mike, we talked about how many kids are returning on this football team. One that is a new position, Marcus Randall, the quarterback. How difficult is it on him? Now, Anderson is a veteran quarterback, and he's been a starter for a long time. For Marcus, wet conditions, wet football, a little bit more of a strain on him, has to be a little bit more focus.
He's waited 5 years. Another 40 minutes is not going to affect him. He needs to get off to a good start, though, because confidence is important. He's 2-4 as a starting quarterback at LSU, but I still think he's going to have a good game.
Mike, let me ask you this. If you're one of these head coaches and you go into the locker room and you talk it over with your offensive and defensive coordinators, do you really change your strategy very much, or you just stick with what you've been working on since the beginning of training camp?
Yeah, it's like the outside games you used to play in a kid. As a kid would go home and he would, you'd have to wait till he came back from dinner. So that's all they're doing right now. They're ready to go. They're focused. Same game plans. Everything's the same.
Nick Saban, and I'll tell you what, he came out about an hour before the team started to warm up, and this stadium went absolutely nuts. The kids treat him and view him as deity. As you take a look across the way, Mike Riley and the Beavers of Oregon State as they take the field. And we saw several of their kids when they came out and the rains were beginning to start, and they were pointing toward the sky and they were applauding like, yeah, hey, we played in this stuff many, many times up in the Great Northwest, and it's not a new situation for us.
Plus, they're Beavers. They like the water.
Well, we got plenty of that here this evening. So Jay Vines, the referee, and here is the toss of the coin.
Receive.
So LSU receives. I believe Oregon State did win the toss, and they deferred until the second half, which is exactly what the situation is. And Mike Riley, the fine young head coach for the Beavers of Oregon State. You see his record, 97-98. Went off to the pros, and his record last year, 8-5. And as you can see the graphic, 1999 and 2000, coached in the pros and then decided to come back up to Oregon State University. You know, Mike, sun is out. The youngsters from Oregon State had just gotten off the bus, and they came out, and you see there are three young men who decided to go out, and they started to dance on the eye of the tiger in the middle of the stadium. Well, in the far background, that's the student section of LSU. They took great exception to it. Now, I don't even know if the LSU team knows that that happened, and it's not important, but I remember we conversed at the time, and sometimes you let a sleeping dog lie, you don't do anything to get them any more fired up than they already are.
Not a good idea.
Number 10, Joseph Addai, junior out of Houston Sharpstown, and Skyler Green, the two deep end. Cerna will kick it off for Oregon State. And we're about 50 minutes behind, but we're underway. High end of our end, short kick. And on the run, it is gathered at the 12 by Skyler Green. Fumbles the ball, recovered, I believe. Let's see. Oregon State football at the 25. Keith Ellison made the recovery.
Wet field, wet ball. Oregon State's got tremendous field position. Just as he starts up the field, got a good hit. He just dropped the football.
Chescott is the man who got the shoulder pad on it right there. Got an arm in and knocked it out. And let's see if the Oregon State Beavers can take advantage of the turnover on the opening kickoff by the LSU Tigers. They're going to throw on first down. Anderson goes on top, near sideline, and the ball is overthrown and incomplete. Travis Daniels with the cover. George Gillette, the intended receiver. Good job of the offensive line of protecting, and there is a flag down. Offensive pass interference against Oregon State.
May have called it on George Gillette, number six. See him come out of his break. Pushing, uses his hands against Travis Daniels.
So a mistake by LSU to open the ball game with the fumble by Skyler Green. And then the pass interference, and this will push the ball back to the 40-yard line. But still around the LSU side of the 50, which is a good start on the road, Mike.
Yeah, Derek Anderson has thrown 50 career touchdown passes.
27th consecutive start for him. 6'6", 240 pounds. The tight end shifts from the right over to the left. Now the flag comes in. And the crowd obviously was a factor there.
Dead ball. First start, number 61. Pulley up. 5 yards. Remain for the snap.
Adam Coates, who is the farthest man from the quarterback and the center. The left tackle is the man who was in motion.
And Ron will watch that left side, the Oregon State's offensive line, because they're brand new, and if they need to protect Derek Anderson.
Anderson went to the sideline to visit with his coaches. Now the penalty moves it back to the 45. So it's going to be first down and 30 for Oregon State. They need to take it down to the 15-yard line. Flag comes from down deep, but they're going to be called for delay of game. Although the pass was thrown complete to Hass, they used too much time.
Last week, it's very difficult now, the start of the ball game, to get used to neutral officials or the SEC officials when you come out of the Pac-10. They've already started the ball a little bit faster than they're used to.
So already three penalties for 25 yards against the Beavers. From the 50. Anderson, quick pass right across the middle, has it complete to Dwight Wright, breaks off a tackle, 40, 35, and it's going to be muscled out of bounds at the 32, but it's a gain of 18 yards. And tonight's starting lineups brought to you by Bridgestone. Dwight Wright, who just cost the pass, is the tailback. Marcel Love is the slotback. Newton, the tight end. Gillette and Hass are the wide receivers. Up front with the offensive line. Coates, Linehan, Brock, Schoening, and Ninehaus. Two tight end alignment. showing blitz, but they stay at home. Pass to the short side of the field. That's complete to Haynes. The tight end's going to take it inside the 25, inside the 20, and it's going to be a gain now of 12. So 30 yards on the last two plays. Turn around the tackle. Defensively, Spears, Roten, Kyle Williams, and Melvin Oliver. The linebackers, Turner, who just made the tackle, he's the veteran. Cameron Vaughn and Quale is a junior college transfer out of Dodge City. And the secondary, Webster and Travis Daniels, maybe as good a corners as college football has. Ron Landry is a very hard-nosed free safety. Jesse Daniels, the strong safety. Third down, they need to take it to the 15-yard line. Good job of protection again, and a pass is thrown complete and pushed out of bounds at the 11 is George Gillette. Now that is a smart job by Travis Daniels, because rather than trying to be over aggressive and getting misfooting on that wet turf, he broke down and was there just to put a hat on him and push it.
You bring up a good point, because the defense is at a disadvantage on a wet field, because you can't make a mistake, slip down, and fall down. Travis Daniels did just that. The offense of Oregon State taking advantage of the defense right now.
Might they have the first down? The ball was way back at the 50-yard line, and they took it inside the 15. First down, pressure was on, and pass is caught right over the middle at the 6-yard line, and that's where Joe Newton will be tackled. Nice defensive pressure. Landry coming up to help on the tackle.
LSU trying to shake up Derek Anderson, bringing the blitz. You see the linebackers both coming right here. Can't get to Derek Anderson, and Joe Newton is 6'7". He's got to have a big game for Derek Anderson to win this football game.
It was Kyle Williams who was applying pressure. Yeah, we watched video yesterday, Mike, with you, and the tight ends, an integral part of this Oregon State offense, and you're right, they are huge. Second down from the 6-yard line, no score, but the Beavers are threatening. Straight in the pocket, Anderson drills the pass in the end zone, incomplete as it's knocked away, throwing into triple coverage. Haynes simply, or Newton, couldn't hold on to the football. One of the guys there again was Landry.
Have not run the football yet. They're going to win this football game throwing it, catching it. There's no Steven Jackson. 25 touchdowns he scored last year. He's gone.
Mike, LaRon Landry came from the backside and reached in and stripped that ball. Otherwise, that would have been a touchdown. Third down, and they need to take it to the one to hold on to the football. Short drop, quick pass, end zone, touchdown, Oregon State. That's George Gillette. Boy, give credit to the offensive line. Coach Lenahan, Brock, Schoening, and Ninehouse. And I mean, they gave him the protection that he needed, and he drilled it for the 6 points.
Pretty good quarterbacking, too. Derek Anderson, very impressive in that first drive, making up for all those penalties.
Cerna comes in to attempt the extra point. Not real high. He hit the upright, and it bounces back onto the field of play. He misses it. Boy, the wet conditions take their toll on the first extra point of the night. So let's take a timeout. 12:08 to play, opening quarter. Oregon State on top first, 6-0.
And the wheel goes round, 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 round. And the wheel goes round and round and round. And the wheel goes round, 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 round.
It's Dueler time. Get a $50 mail-in rebate when you buy four select Bridgestone Dueler tires.
Boy, oh boy, you think no one sees. But if a gal's minivan came home with as many dings as are in your golf shoe, there'd be unpleasant words. Don't bring soccer into a man's game. Gentlemen, be forewarned. In the treacherous ethical waters ahead, you'll meet two kinds. Men who live the high life. And those who need to.
We'll be right back. Hyundai Sonata is J.D. Power & Associates' highest-ranked entry midsize car in initial quality. Be prepared for a little extra attention. The Sonata from Hyundai.
Somewhere, there's a man accessing sensitive information by way of a fingerprint, while a woman keeps track of millions of dollars in inventory, safeguarding it from the warehouse to your house. And a dad checks on his business from his son's baseball game. What do all these people have in common? They rely on America's number one security company, ADT. Always there.
So the Oregon State cheerleaders, they're not bothered by the wet weather here in Baton Rouge. They got a lot to cheer about. Their team came right down the field, and it looked as though, Mike, they were going to not take advantage of a very good situation. They got penalties from the 25 all the way back to the 50-yard line and still came back, picked up the first, and marched it on into score.
LSU's speed on defense has been affected by this wet field.
Yeah.
They're not as fast. They're tentative on moving in the secondary.
Scott Green, along with Joseph Adai, the two deep men. Cerna kicks it off. Very high, and again, it's short. It's going to come to Adai at the 15. Joe Adai back into the middle, across the 25 to the 26. And let's check down on the sideline with Aaron Andrews. Aaron.
Hi, Ron. Well, I spoke to head coach Mike Riley of Oregon State as he was walking out from the locker room. He said they kept it very calm in there during the rain delay. He also said, thank goodness for the rain, because it's cooled off considerably. He said the team has practiced some wet ball drills during the summer. The unfortunate thing is it was never muddy when they practiced it, so that could be interesting for Oregon State, Ron.
Well, they'll get an opportunity tonight, Aaron, because it's wet and it is muddy. Straight ahead with a handoff, and hit immediately, Justin Vincent, as Keith Ellison comes from his strong linebacking side. And the starting lineups brought to you by Bridgestone. Vincent and Stelts in the backfield. David Jones, the tight end. Bo and Scott Green, the wide receivers. Scott Green, not 100%. He's got a high ankle sprain, which we'll talk more about. Whitworth and Wilkerson, both All-American preseason candidates. Will Arnold is the new face, the guy at left guard. Miz Wanger and Nate Livings on the right side at guard and at tackle. And there he is, Marcus Randall, a five-year senior. But the first time that it's been his ball club. Ball is thrown, and it is intercepted. Picked off by Pescatelli as the ball was tipped. And the pressure from Joe Lima is what caused it to happen. And hang on, the Tiger defense is going to have to batten the hatches, because right now the Beavers try to blow this thing open early.
Never should have thrown this football. You talked about the pressure from Joe Lima. Piscatelli sitting on the route right here, and he throws it wide. David Jones was the intended target, but Marcus Randall, that's not what you want to get him off to a good, confident start to happen.
First, they took it over at the 25 of LSU. After this turnover, they get it at the 23. And Anderson to throw on first down right over the middle. Well overthrown on that one. In fact, the closest person to it was Corey Webster, the cornerback on the far side. I think Anthony Wheat Brown might have been the intended receiver.
Ron, I talked to Derek Anderson before the game, and he talked about he's from Scappoose, Oregon. He said, I asked him, how big is Scappoose, Oregon? He said, as big as that student body, pointing to the side of the stadium. So not a big town, but I'll tell you, he was ready to go.
Only needs one touchdown pass. He becomes second on the all-time list for the Beavers. They go with Wright. Straight ahead. He'll take it for a couple of yards, maybe three, to the 20. Tripped up by Kyle Williams.
The run will only be used as a weapon to keep and set up the passing game. If they're going to win this football game, they're going to win it through the air.
Mike, I think that is their first run. Scrimmage.
First run.
Marcel Love comes into the lineup, number 16. Keep an eye on him. Speedster out of San Francisco Community College. LSU, here they come with the blitz. On the open side of the field, right over the middle, the ball is intercepted, and that's going to be picked off by LaRon Landry, the outstanding sophomore free safety out of Ama, Louisiana. And that's a ball that never should have been thrown either.
If there's one knock on Derek Anderson, he throws, he forces some footballs, and he gets some interceptions. He's trying to go to Joe Newton, 89, but he gets pressure, and he threw off his back foot. He never got set.
Kyle Williams again, Mike, and he's come with a couple of pressures already tonight. Smart thing by Landry is with the wet field, instead of trying to cut it upfield, take it out of bounds and get the ball safely at the 20.
24 interceptions last year for Derek Anderson. Not a good throw.
Justin Benson, the lone setback, and he is about 8 yards behind the center. Comes to the left side. Nice open field tackle. It'll be a gain of 3 by Trent Bray. Was an outside linebacker last year.
Derek Anderson has had some problems on the road. 14 touchdowns, but 25 interceptions. So, and that was costly because they could at least made an attempt to pick up 3.
No, you're right, Mike. I mean, that's a situation where you just have to
throw it away.
Yeah, throw it away. Don't get greedy because you've got the home team on the ropes. At least make it a 10-point lead. Don't lose everything. Flag is down. I believe the left guard, Will Arnold, came out of his stance before the ball was snapped.
LSU's defense rose to the occasion.
Dead ball. Ball starting on the 73 against the offense. 5 yards. Remains touchdown.
So let's check in quickly with Reese Davis. Reese.
All right, Ron. Taco Bell taking us to the other Death Valley where we have a barn burner. Wake and Clemson. Clemson down 2. This is a 2-point conversion, and Charlie Whitehurst hits Kelvin Grant, and they are playing in overtime. Wake and Clemson locked up at 27.
Wow, he just took it away from him right over the top. Some kind of ball game up at Clemson, South Carolina today. Joseph Addai comes in the ball game, but he's at wide receiver, not at tailback. They roll from the shotgun. Pass thrown, got him complete, and knocked out of bounds at the 34-yard line. And that is Dwayne Bowe who makes the catch, gain of 15. And the initial first down of the night for the Tigers. Lima, Seeger, Sir Henry Anderson, and Bill Swancutt, the down for Bill Swancutt, an outstanding player. Many people have him on their all-conference list. Ellison, Bray, and Pollard are the linebackers. And in the secondary, Williams and Browner at the corners. Musin, the free safety, and the strong safety is Savvy Piscatelli, who had the pickoff earlier on. This time for maybe a yard as they took him back into the short side of the field, and Jonathan Pollard came over to make the tackle.
Oregon State last year against the run only gave up 84 yards rushing per game. They're a difficult team to run against. Where you got to look for something out of Skylar Green, number 5, who's going to be in a slot back. He's going to be working against linebackers, and he's going to be working against safeties.
Again, Joe Addai in the ball game at wide receiver. And the ball comes to Addai, turns the corner, gets by one tackle, and is going to be spinning and turning and finally stopped. I believe he got a first down around the 46. It's a gain of 9 as Trent Bray comes over to make the tackle. Well, they've used Addai already, wide receiver, and now a tailback.
Joseph Addai is a power running back, so this field conditions fit him.
Mike, you know what he was in high school? At Sharpstown High School in Houston, he was an option quarterback. And the coaches have raved about his effort during training camp because they took him from tailback to wide receiver, and he said he's worked really hard and hasn't complained a bit. He just wants to play. Justin Vincent comes back into tailback. Randall drills this one too high, had the man open at the 40. That's Dwayne Bowe, and it'll go incomplete.
Well, you can only think about Marcus Randall. His mom and brother told him, hey, you know, just have patience. Your time will come. Good things come to those who wait. And he's waited 5 years for this opportunity. You know he's a little nervous. He wants to go, and he wants to make things happen.
Well, he was the roommate with Matt Mock last year, and I'm sure he learned a lot there, even though he was not the starter. But in talking with Matt, who was the starter on this ball club for the last 2 years until injury took him away down at Florida year before last. Vincent, nice job of containment and the tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Oregon State's Musin, the free safety, and let's check back with Reese Davis.
All right, Ron, let's check in now on Rutgers and Michigan State. Rutgers with a 5-point lead. Michigan State, its last chance. Damon Dowdell, Eric Knott, has to get the first down to keep the drive alive, and he does not. Fumble the ball, but he wasn't close to the stick. Rutgers wins it by 5.
Okay, Reese, shocker right there. Third down, they need to take it to the 44-yard line of Oregon State to keep this drive going. And again from the shotgun from Marcus Randall. Flag goes down, wide receiver on the near side, left too quickly. Ball is caught, he breaks out of a tackle. Bo is going to take it the distance and it'll have to come back. I believe he is the man who jumped too quickly and it's going to be a 57-yard touchdown.
Ron, I think it may have been Joseph Addai that moved too fast, too. We'll see who it is.
Well, we'll get the call, and he'll give the number.
Yeah, I think it was Joseph Addai.
On the offense.
Didn't give the number, Ron, but I believe it's Joseph Addai. Watch him right here. He starts too soon, trying to get down this football field. He's a little bit across the line of scrimmage.
Yep, you are exactly right. Boy, so a beauty. 57 yards, comes back. You just joined us at 6-0 Oregon State. We have 7 minutes left to play in his opening quarter. Two turnovers early by the Tigers. The Beavers took care of business on the first one, but did not on the second turnover and gave it right back to LSU, but it was picked off and intercepted by LaRon Landry. So a timeout's been called. We'll take it with him. 6-0. We'll be back with more from Baton Rouge.
ESPN, happy 25 years. I hope you have 125 better than it in the next 125. Good luck to you. Chris Berman, you're the man, baby.
That is sweet.
My pride and joy. Oh,
it looks new.
Like right out of the showroom.
Oh, that is one great looking...
Whoa, hold on, honey. I'm showing Tom the floor.
Nice floor, Joan.
Make your garage floor the envy of the neighborhood. You can do it yourself with Rust-Oleum Epoxy Shield Garage Floor Coating. After prep, you're ready to go. Simple as painting a wall. Easy to clean and resists chipping and peeling. This all-inclusive kit is available at home centers, hardware stores, and automotive retailers near you. And now, transform your unfinished basement with Epoxy Shield Basement Floor Coating.
Sonata is J.D. Power & Associates' highest-ranked entry midsize car in initial quality. Be prepared for a little extra attention. The Sonata from Hyundai.
Bob, where are you?
Boise.
Boise? Where's my proposal?
I just sent it to BizHub.
BizHub?
BizHub's in Boise?
BizHub is next to your office. Near the fax machine?
BizHub is a fax machine.
Fax? I need it in color.
I printed it in color.
But you're in Boise, Bob.
I'm printing to BizHub from Boise. You've got a BizHub.
We all have a BizHub.
Surprising versatility and amazing affordable color. That's BizHub from Konica Minolta.
I got a BizHub?
ESPN's College Football Saturday Primetime is presented by Rust-Oleum Epoxy Shield for the ultimate garage floor. And in part by Hyundai. When your car comes with America's best warranty, you win. Hyundai.
And we are back 6-0. Oregon State on top. And look who's coming to the ball game on offense. All-American cornerback, defensive specialist Corey Webster. And they said they might use him on offense some. And they have elected to do so. Third down. Randall sets deep in the pocket, looks going to go long, and this one is just well overthrown. Down around the 20-yard line, Piscatelli was the closest man to it.
Big pressure by Bill Swancutt, the All-American candidate, knocking Marcus Randall to the ground. Swancutt, number 90, gets by the offensive line. A good tackle on Marcus Randall. Didn't look like Corey Webster was running full speed on that play.
Patrick Fisher comes in to punt. It's his first of the night. And in fact, this end of the field has had all the action. There's been virtually nothing at the other end. Here's the boot. Wobbly driving spiral. And it's going to be taken. The ball is fumbled. And he'll recover it at the 11-yard line. Kellen Marshall never should have jumped up and caught the ball anyway. Bernard, I beg your pardon. 46 yards in the kick, minus 5 on the return. And Ronnie Prude is a man who took him almost in half.
I think Mike Riley's going to tell him, don't play that football. He's made an unwise decision, but smart enough to recover the football.
Ronnie Prude with the big hit, waited on the field to see what alignment they were going to use. If he'd be in as a nickelback. Coming into the ballgame for Oregon State is Ryan Cole, number 33. Now, the worst field position that Oregon State has had tonight at their own 11-yard line. In fact, they have their backs to the LSU student section. LSU jams up at the line of scrimmage. Anderson, good protection, got the ball complete, and a nice open field tackle. Newton is hit immediately by LaRon Landry, but it's a gain of 16.
Newton has to come up big. We talked about that early in the broadcast. He's a 6'7 tight end that runs very well coming across the field. You see him coming across right here. And all of a sudden, Anderson delivers to the big target against Landry. Get out of that hole.
So they gain a little room to breathe here out to the 28. First down. Ball is fumbled on the ground. We'll wait for a signal. LSU football. Dorsey is the man who made the recovery. The freshman out of Gonzales.
The handoff was bad from the start. Derek Anderson doesn't get the football because
he
Ryan
slipped.
Cole slipped.
Sure did.
Didn't have his hands ready. Kyle Williams in on the play.
Well, Kyle Williams already has caused a stir as far as the Oregon State Beavers offense. So LSU with their best field position of the afternoon at the 25-and-a-half-yard line. Vincent again with a very deep set of tailback, 8 yards off the ball, gets the handoff, tries to make a little stagger step, and with this wet footing, that's going to be hard to do, and as Mike made the point of, Oregon State's very hard to run on. Siegert is the man who got him.
I really believe the field conditions favor Oregon State for what they do. They're good run-stopping defense, and they're good throwing the football, so bad news for LSU on both sides of the ball.
Tough situation on the grounds crew here at LSU. They put the tarp on the field yesterday, and it was just a downpour. And it was in perfect condition. And 10 minutes before game time is when we had the next downpour.
On Skyler Green, inside receiver.
Rolls to his left, looking under heavy pressure. Going to put that ball away. And is going to fight his way inside the 20, down to around the 12-and-a-half-yard line. Eric Williams comes over to make the tackle.
Marcus Randall may be settling down a little bit. He made a wise choice to run that football on that play. Oregon State had all the receivers covered. Marcus Randall did a good thing and ran the football. Picked up big yardage.
So third down, they need to take it to the 15-and-a-half-yard line. Clock goes under 5 minutes to play opening quarter. Oregon State 6, LSU nothing. Randall from a shotgun. And he'll pitch it back inside to Skyler Green. Going to be hit behind the line of scrimmage. And how about the play by Bill Swancutt? You see why he's on all-conference and many All-American lists. And folks, we've visited with the kid this past week. He no nonsense. He just wants to play and contribute.
Ron, he's an All-American football player. He said the left coast teams don't get the, they get the shaft, and he's going to make sure they don't get it. But he plays relentlessly.
Well, the coach has said he's a playmaker, and he made one right there. Jackson with a 41-yard attempt. Hit this one way, way, way too deep. Almost like you ground your club in golf, and that one is going to be wide to the right and no good, so we'll take a timeout. Tigers get a turnover but cannot do anything with it. They still trail 6-0. Right back.
One day you wake up and find a few hairs on your pillow. Next day, they're dribbling your head down the court.
Get V for Men Thickening Shampoo for up to 50% thicker looking hair for better scalp coverage. V for Men by L'Oreal Paris.
From Philips comes the only flat TV with built-in ambient light technology, which changes color with whatever you're watching, so you are completely surrounded by the experience. A new Philips flat TV with Ambilight.
Hey there.
Irresistible taste of Pringles. Nothing pops, crunches, and tastes like Pringles.
Can you celebrate too much? Not when it's this big. Happy 100th birthday to Haviland. Add more life to your car.
Well, Mike the Tiger with the roar before the football game tonight, then the rains came. And right now, the team that's done all the roaring has been Oregon State. They lead it 6-0 with 4:05 to play in the opening quarter. As you look at Derek Anderson, senior out of Scappoose, Oregon. Ryan Cole operates a tailback, replacing Dwight Wright. Fakes it to Cole, going to go on top, and the ball just a little too far. Intended for Mike Haz and Reese Davis. Let's check back with you.
Okay, Ron, Sylvester Croom's debut at Mississippi State. Bulldogs taking on Tulane. Tulane was on the move until Lester Ricard threw an interception. Clarence McDougal there for State. They are scoreless at halftime on ESPN2.
All righty. Kyle Williams with pressure on that play right there. And in this first quarter, we have mentioned his name a great number of times. And the 95 has been busy. Second and 10. Anderson, five step drop. Ball is intercepted and dropped. Wow, Ronnie Prude, after making the big hit on special teams, had an opportunity to make an even bigger hit, and he dropped the football.
Ron, that was six. Ronnie Prude is not going to get a better interception opportunity this season. Throw it right to him. Again, another mistake by Derek Anderson. Sometimes he wants to force the ball in there when it's not there.
And Mike, his receiver was falling down. He just, it's like the interception that he threw to Landry. He just trying to get a little too greedy. Third down now. They need to take it to the 34-yard line to keep it going. Wright comes back into tailback. Here comes pressure. They set the middle screen. Ball to tip. Almost intercepted. Melvin Oliver is the man who got a hand on it. And he is lucky that that one wasn't picked off and returned for 6 points.
LSU's defense really got a pretty good beat on Oregon State's offense. Melvin Oliver gets his big hands up there, 6'3", and knocks that ball away.
That was Pittman who almost came up with the interception. And I'll tell you, from where this ball was tipped, if he had caught it, he was in a position to take it in and score.
LSU very good on special teams.
Gets the kick away. And miraculously, he got it away, and the ball goes out of bounds, and it's not very far. That's 25 yards in the boot. And let's take another look at it.
Oregon State really now is making a lot of mistakes. LSU has to make them pay for it. Very fortunate to get that football away. Now good field position again for Marcus Randall to take over the offense.
Valescu just had come into the ball game and dropped the snap. And if you're looking for the pot of gold, it's just out of the south end zone. Justin Vincent in a tailback, and he'll get the handoff. They try the right side, bounces it out and down inside the 45-yard line. Piscatelli is the man who comes up to make the stop. Well, the miscues by LSU. They fumbled the opening kickoff, led to 6 points by Oregon State. Motion penalty negated a 57-yard touchdown and then missed a 31-yard field goal. Early Doucette comes into the ballgame. An outstanding freshman from St. Martinville, Louisiana, wears number 9. Benson with the pitch. Hurdles one man. Whoa, does he get met and sent backwards by Trent Bray, the middle linebacker. And that's going to be a loss of about 3 yards.
One thing I see right now, when LSU's in the two-back set, 9 people are around the line of scrimmage. Difficult to run against that. Oregon State pretty solid on run defense. Got to throw the football. Still waiting for number 5, Skylar Green, to get off here.
Joe Adai comes back into the lineup, number 10. LSU on third down conversions. They are 0 of 2. Randall under pressure. Flag comes down. That may be offensive holding. Going to run, and he's tackled at the 41-yard line by Bray. But I believe we got holding back here at midfield.
I think it's on Whitworth against Swancutt, Ron. He's having trouble with the defensive end, the All-American, Bill Swancutt. Whitworth, we figured this is going to be a battle the whole game. We talked to Bill Swancutt, and we asked him, did you see anything about Whitworth? He said, I know he's 6'7 and 325 pounds, and he moves well.
Well, there's a look at Andrew Whitworth right there, junior out of West Monroe. Hey, we'll have to isolate on that matchup a little bit and see exactly what's happening.
Number 76 on the offense. That is declined. It'll be fourth down.
Yeah, Bill Swancutt's having his way. He's got a wide rush technique. And Whitworth's out on an island right here, Swancutt. And as he comes in, he grabs a hold of him. He beat him on the spin move.
Part of the mistake that Whitworth made is using the inside, and he put himself, as Mike said, out there by himself on an island, and that was the difference. Chris Jackson in the ball game to kick, end over end. And they're going to let it go, and the ball is going to be touched at the 1 yard line. And they're going to say touchback.
You may see a different guy returning punts the next punt.
Well, Daniel Francis
he saw his foot on the end zone before he got rid of the football. Good effort. I'm not sure he didn't get it out.
Dwight Wright comes back in a tailback. Anderson throws it complete. Tackled immediately is Dan Haynes. And I tell you, the tight ends have been very busy tonight for Oregon State. Ron Franklin, Mike Gottfried, and Aaron Andrews coming to you from a jam-packed Baton Rouge, Louisiana Tiger Stadium. Well, actually, I need to be correct. We're about 10 short of capacity because about 10 people got arrested for running out of the field during the rainstorm, and the police were out there lining them up and getting them into the paddy wagon.
Something in the water.
Is what they put the water in. Pass out in the flat again. We got it to the tight end. This time it's going to be Haynes. And let's see if he got the first down. He's very close at the 29-yard line. Jesse Daniels out there to make the stop.
Oregon State staying with their game plan. Paul Chris, the offensive coordinator, using the pass to set up everything else.
Haynes now with three catches for 21.
And you know, the receiver I thought would be a big factor, too, is Mike Haas, number 28. Over here.
We'll see if they get him involved here. Third down and short, though. Well, they are going to throw. Right up in the middle, got it complete. And that's going to be to George Gilbert. Or George Gillette, I beg your pardon.
That's the respect the Beavers have for the Tiger defense. Because 2 yards or less, they're going to throw the football. But that's their offense. They're riding the shoulders and the arm of Derek Anderson, the 6'6 senior.
E.J. Qualley, strong side linebacker, comes out of the lineup. And Ronnie Prude comes in as the fifth defensive back for the Tigers. First and 10 from their own 35. Pass overthrown because the receiver slipped down at the 41-yard line. That was Joe Newton, who they were throwing it to.
Derek Anderson threw almost 500 yards against USC's defense last season. So he's played against very fine football teams. LSU's defense, every bit as good as USC's defense, but having problems slipping on this field.
Well, they stack the wide receivers out to the left. Anderson, good protection. The ball is tipped and almost intercepted. It's Travis Daniels who had a hand on it. And I'll tell you, folks, he's lucky he hasn't been picked off three times already in that opening quarter. Let's take a break. That's the end of the first 15 minutes of play. 6-0. Oregon State, big underdogs. Right now, they are on top. We'll be right back.
CS is presented by Russell Athletic. During their 2002 national championship run, Ohio State's undefeated season needed some major heroics. Trailing 6-3 with under 2 minutes to play against Purdue, Buckeye QB Craig Krenzel answered the call.
Krenzel's going to throw for it.
Associates' highest-ranked entry midsize car in initial quality. Be prepared for a little extra attention. The Sonata from Hyundai.
When Stan Ross got his 3,000th hit, he made history and he became Mr. 3,000.
Bring the whole family to Mr. 3,000 shopping center.
But 10 years later, his life changed.
Three of the hits don't count.
What type of boy is that?
Now,
I'm getting three more hits.
The comeback begins.
What do you think, Grandpa? Grandpa.
Bernie Mac.
First week in bat was like his first week out of the womb. A whole lot of just flailing around.
Mr. 3,000, rated PG-13.
Press one.
From Philips comes the only flat TV with built-in ambient light technology, which changes color with whatever you're watching, so you are completely surrounded by the experience. A new Philips flat TV with Ambilight.
Now through Monday, Zales is having a store-wide sale where you can save up to 60% off and more throughout the store. Like this 3-carat diamond bracelet for just $279, our lowest price ever. Quantities are limited. At Zales, the diamond store.
ESPN puts the spotlight on the highlight with ESPN 25 The Book. Available now.
So we are back as we continue to look at the rainbow just outside the stadium, and hopefully those blue skies will become dominant and we will be done with the rain this evening. Had a delay of, I guess we're about 50 minutes late in starting. Third down, and Oregon State needs to take it to the 44-and-a-half-yard line to keep this drive alive. LSU's got six defensive backs in the ballgame. Anderson drills it, has it complete, and I'll tell you, I think Wright has the first down. Gain of 11 yards in the play.
Ron, 18 passes, only two runs. That's going to wear out this defensive front of LSU. Pass rushing and not getting to Derek Anderson. Good catch by Haas.
Hawkins will come into the lineup, number three. Lionel Turner on that last tackle. Boy, they really picked him there. They got it in the one hole that was available. Haynes was in motion, but they go straight ahead with the run. Reese Davis, let's check back with you.
Ron, again in the other Death Valley, Clemson and Wake Forest in double overtime, tied at 30. Charlie Whitehurst, beautifully designed play. Kyle Browning goes in. Now Wake Forest has a chance. 37-30. Corey Randolph looking for Willie Idelet, and oh, he had him open and missed him, and Clemson hangs on by 7.
Boy, what a finish. Double overtime. The Tigers win. Second down. Short drop again. The ball is thrown complete at the 45. Corey Webster was all over him, but has held on to the football. Not quite enough for the first down, so they're going to have a third down at about 1.
Haas is a former walk-on and earned a scholarship last year in preseason camp. Great catch. Low ball away from Corey Webster. Well thrown by Derek Anderson.
He had over 1,000 yards last year. Very powerful young man.
Here's where they may have problems right here, running for 1 yard.
LSU jams the line of scrimmage. They go straight ahead, and they're going to have the first down as he plows his way to around the 43-and-a-half-yard line. Turner on the stop, and Aaron Andrews down on the sideline with a famous LSU graduate. Who you got?
That's right, Ron. I'm here right now with Shaquille O'Neal. Shaq, what is one of your greatest memories here in Baton Rouge?
Actually, one of my greatest moments when I was on my recruitment. And I sat in that end zone over there and announced my name, and the crowd went crazy. That's why I decided to come to LSU.
Well, I see you wearing the national championship football hat right now. Did you ever have thoughts of putting some pads on and playing out here for the Tigers?
I'm not that good, no. But congratulations, Nick Saban and the city of Baton Rouge. They deserve it.
All right, stand by.
So the sack. He's got to be stopped. That's the first time they've gotten to him at the 50. Aaron, let's go back to you. Continue your conversation with Shaq.
All right. Well, Shaq, you're looking pretty slim. I know a lot of women would like to know what your secret is getting ready to play for the Miami Heat. What are you, on the South Beach diet or something?
I don't have a secret. I'm just sexy.
Before you go, Hurricane Francis down there in South Florida. How's your house holding up?
My house is pretty good. I just want to wish everybody luck. Hopefully no one gets injured or hurt. And I wish everybody well.
Shaq, thanks so much.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks very much, Aaron. Shaquille O'Neal played basketball here, of course. Came back and got his degree a couple of years ago, maybe 3. Anderson's pass, and that one is going to be caught at the 43-yard line. And it's a Haas who was on the receiving end. Corey Webster had to cover on him, and Haas did the only thing he could do, kind of plane out to make the catch.
Really, Haas is an excellent receiver, getting open, using his body, and makes that catch. Last year, he averaged 23 yards per catch, had 44 receptions. He's a go-to guy for Derek Anderson.
Well, somebody needs to be right now because it's third down. They need to take it to the 33-and-a-half-yard line. Anderson, good protection, right over the middle, and he threw it too hard and maybe behind Mike Hass.
Boy, he'd like to have that one back, Ron, because he got great protection, and Hass came open late. Here's the protection. Nobody gets to him. He overthrows this football. He knows he made a mistake, because if Hass catches that football, he's off and running.
Pulescu in for his second punt of the afternoon. Scott Green, the deep man, end over end on the kick, and Green is going to run away from it, and it takes an Oregon State bounce, and it is just going to go dead as a hammer right there at the 7-yard line as Sammy Strother came in to make the recovery. Only 35 on the kick. LSU will have horrible field position.
Want something spicy? Taco Bell is open late. Feed your need for all the spicy, grilled, marinated, crunchy, and melty taste you can only get at Taco Bell. Want to spice up the night? Think outside the bun. Open till midnight or later.
Nissan Altima, sleek lines. Xterra, aggressive lines. Frontier, riveting lines. Of all the thrilling lines that Nissan brings you, this may be the most interesting. The bottom line at the Nissan National Sales Event. Get 1% financing or up to $2,500 cash back on select new Nissans. But hurry, September 7th is the end of the line. See your Nissan dealer now.
Hey, Dad, when I'm 10, how old will you be?
52.
How old will you be when I'm 18?
She goes to college the same year you plan to retire. Are you ready for this? Now you can be. See your State Farm agent and plan your financial future with the company you trust. We live where you live.
Does Mom know how old you are?
So we are back. Shaquille O'Neal tries to make his way through the base of the student section, and it's rather difficult to do. By the way, for LSU, Mike, 15 snaps, only 37 net yards. And we have 11:02 left to play until halftime.
Need a big play. Oregon State's defense not going to give you the big play.
Benson comes to the right side, and again, Oregon State has been really impressive with their tackling. Here's a reminder, Show Your Spirit Day of September the 7th. Wear your favorite team's apparel to work, and in exchange, each participant can make a $5 donation or more to the V Foundation to benefit cancer research. Anyone can participate. For more details, log on to www.jimmyb.org.
Jimmy B, spent some time up with him at ESPN. He was a guy with tremendous enthusiasm for life. Great basketball coach.
Huge underdog, won a national championship over the Houston Cougars out in Albuquerque. Play action. Randall throws the ball low and behind the receiver, and he gets Skyler Green in trouble, and instead of even at the line of scrimmage, they're going to be knocked down for a loss as Piscatelli was all over it.
Yeah, Piscatelli is the fastest guy on this football team for Oregon State. He closed fast on Skyler Green. Skyler Green really doesn't have an opportunity to run this football.
Mike and Marcus Randall, when he gets in a hurry, the point of the football is down, and it makes it a more difficult ball to catch.
Bobbled it on that play.
Two turnovers each. You see, total yards in this one, Oregon State 105, 39 for LSU. Backside pressure. Randall now delivers it. Has a man there, and I'll tell you, they had to play defensive back as Williams was there, and Joe Adai actually knocked the ball down.
One thing about these two corners for Oregon State, Eric Williams and Brandon Browner, they'll challenge you. Eric Williams Pierce does a great job on this play, getting past the die to help deflect that football.
You see what the die did, though? He was knocking it down because he knew he couldn't catch it. Patrick Fisher, redshirt freshman out of Hyattsville, Maryland. His second punt of the night, his first 46 yards. So you have to get it up because you don't get much roll in this soggy turf. Another line drive, lazy spiral, and he lets this one get by. Wow. Mike, I have a feeling Bernard was the man who let it get by him. But you're right, they may be trying a couple of...
Get the ESPN Game Plan College Football Pay-Per-View Package featuring more than 150 extra games this season. To order, call your local cable company, DirecTV, or Dish Network.
Chiseled. Muscular. Powerful. Of all the thrilling lines that Nissan brings you, this may be the most interesting. The bottom line. At the Nissan National Sales Event, it's an extraordinary time to get the all-new full-size Nissan Titan with 2% financing or $1,500 cash back. But hurry. September 7th is the end of the line. See your Nissan dealer now.
Leon, what's the matter? You hurt?
I think so, Coach. That last play, I think I hurt my psyche.
Your psyche?
Yeah, when I dropped the ball and all the fans booed, it hurt my feelings pretty bad. It's going to be difficult for me to get back out there again today. Leon just might need a little Leon time to kind of sort some things out.
Leon time?
Yeah.
Well, maybe a nice cup of herbal tea would make you feel better.
Herbal tea? Maybe, Coach.
So should I get him the tea? Now this is big.
This Saturday only, find red-hot deals store-wide during the Sizzlin' Saturday sale at Radio Shack.
It's so big, it's
this DVD-VCR combo for $79.99 after rebate. This digital camera only $39.99. And save 10% on in-store products when you open a new Radio Shack Answers Plus credit card account.
It doesn't get any bigger than this.
The Sizzlin' Saturday sale at Radio Shack. You've got questions, we've got answers. And check out Bernie Mac and Mr. 3000, rated PG-13, in theaters September 17th.
ESPN's College Football Saturday Primetime, brought to you by Nissan, who invites you to shift the way you move through the world. And Budweiser. Grab a cold, fresh Budweiser. It's game time.
Part of the capacity house here in Baton Rouge at Tiger Stadium. Ryan Cole is coming to ballgame at tailback for the Beavers of Oregon State as Anderson goes under center. 9-11 left until halftime. Ball is tipped at the line of scrimmage, and that one could have been picked off. I believe it's Brian West, a sophomore out of West Monroe, who got a hand on it. Mike, this ball game, it's interesting. A lot of people said that man right there, the head coach Mike Riley at Oregon State, was crazy. He was to have played Temple today. His game came open because Virginia Tech wanted to play in the Black Coaches game, which was last week. And Frank Beamer said, we don't want to play SC one week and then have to go to Baton Rouge the next. So they LSU moved the game to 07. And we'll give you more explanation here after this play. Again, right over the middle, has it complete, and that is to Wheatbrow. The point is, everybody was shocked when Coach Riley said, hey, we'll go down there and play in Baton Rouge, and people said, you're crazy. But I tell you, he has used this as a total positive, and right now it's really going in his direction.
It really is. Now, Temple got beat badly today, and that game was supposed to be at Oregon State, but Mike Riley, as a head coach, Ron, is loose as a goose. He enjoys coaching. He enjoys the sideline. He made this decision. He had helped him in recruiting. It helped him and his fans, and they're excited about it. Plus, he gets a big paycheck.
Well, they made the first down, and this is what Mike's talking about. The paycheck, or payday, is $1 million. Great classroom here in Baton Rouge, extensive media coverage. And also, he said, it helps in recruiting, and all of the above is exactly right. And, of course, we've got a lot of time to play here, even if they lose this football game. I really salute him, and I think it was an extremely wise move to make.
Yeah, it really was, because it helped him in recruiting, and it's helped his football team right now. Because like Virginia Tech, it helped them play in USC. State in this football game.
And you know, Mike, we're finding out in all sports, particularly West Coast against East Coast, or even if it's West Coast against Heartland, these kids on the West Coast, they come on later, and a lot of people don't get to see their programs. And Swan Cut was one who said, hey, we're not being cocky, but we've got something we want to show. We want to prove to some people we're pretty good out here.
It's a little easier now, too, with the passing game. Derek Anderson, they're throwing the football all over the ballpark here.
Second down, they need to take it to the LSU 40. And it's going to be Ryan Cole who will take it for about a gain of a yard. And Reese Davis has checked back with you.
All right, Ron. Sylvester Croom in Mississippi State against Tulane after a pickoff by Darren Williams of Mississippi State. Jarius Norwood in the house, the first touchdown of the Croom era. And the Bulldogs run top of Tulane, 7-0 in the third quarter.
We met Sylvester down at the ESPN meetings in Florida. I'm convinced he's going to do a great job at State.
Certainly got a lot of respect from young and old in the state of Mississippi. Pressure coming right up the middle. Flags are down, and that pass almost intercepted. And this time it was LaRon Landry who had an opportunity for the pickoff.
That's about four.
At least.
that they've had a shot at. Got to turn this down.
On number 28, the offense is declined. Fourth down.
Forced the punt. Oregon State happy with the fact that they're going to pin LSU back.
So it means Scott Green will go back deep at the 10-yard line. And Pulescu will be waiting for the snap back at his own 40-yard line. Scott Green with a high ankle sprain in a scrimmage a week ago. And he's really done a masterful job of quick recovery. High kick, he runs away from it. And it bounces. Is it going to get in the end zone? Yep, it did, but I mean just barely. 46 yards on the kick, and we'll take a timeout. 7:09 remaining until intermission, and it's still 6-0, Oregon State.
Nissan Altima, sleek lines. Xterra, aggressive lines. Frontier, riveting lines. Of all the thrilling lines that Nissan brings you, this may be the most interesting. The bottom line at the Nissan National Sales Event. Get 1% financing or up to $2,500 cash back on select new Nissans. But hurry, September 7th is the end of the line. See your Nissan dealer now.
Let's face it, stuff happens. If you're in a wreck with an 18-wheeler, you need an experienced, aggressive attorney.
Call attorney Michael Hingle at 1-800-USA-JURY.
If you're in a wreck with a big rig, we'll take them to court and you'll be as big as they are.
Michael Hingle has offices in Baton Rouge and Hammond.
Call attorney Michael Hingle at 1-800-USA-JURY.
Before you accept a quick check, check with me.
Until halftime, 6-0, Oregon State on top. And as we mentioned, heavy, heavy underdogs in this one to come into Baton Rouge and play. First and 10 for the Tigers for their own 20. Vincent again lines up a tailback. Blitz coming off the corner. They swing it out, and this is Vincent. 25. Stretches out around the 29-yard line.
Ron, nothing is coming easy for LSU in offense. Randall gets stuck right there. The good tackling defense of Oregon State. They hit you. Here's the pass to Scott Green. He's right on top of him. Joseph Addai. Is there a intended receiver here, but nothing is going easy. Everything under duress for LSU on offense.
And not good decisions. That pass there that Adai had to play defensive back on. And the one out on the flat, it's like they were in bump coverage and he still threw the ball. Almost break the run on that one as Bray will make the tackle. It'll be enough for the first down. Bray, we have unofficially six tackles on him.
Ron, the backup quarterback is DeMarcus Russell from Mobile, Alabama, and he is not ready. I can tell you that watching him in practice. See, he's going to be a great player. Nick Saban said, I want to get him in early in the season, not necessarily in this football game, but I got to get him some playing time.
So it's a first down for the Tigers. As now they scrimmage from their own 34, and that's going to be, he better get after that. That ball is thrown behind him. Now I'm going to be anxious to see if they bring this back to the line of scrimmage, because it sure looked like it was a backwards pass.
I think it's going back to the line of scrimmage.
Okay, see where it goes. Doucette was the intended receiver. Very close. And Doucette will be reminded that on every ball like that, you go after it just in case. Here comes pressure. They set up the screen, and he just throws it away.
Smart move by Marcus Randall, because they were all over that play.
Well, Siegert, you're supposed to allow the defensive lineman through, but Siegert was maybe a little closer than he was supposed to be.
Yeah, they had a twist going on, but they locked up man for man. And sometimes when you get a man coverage against the screen, that's not a good way to do it. QB comparison. Randall, 3 of 9, 26 yards.
LSU 0 of 4, third down conversions. Defensive back at Bray slipped down, trying to figure out who in the world he was throwing to. Nobody with an LSU headgear over there.
Ron, when you have good corners like Eric Williams and Brandon Browner, you can do a lot of things in coverage. They are outstanding corners.
Fisher to kick it away. And Bernard is the deep man for Oregon State. Off the side of his foot. Wow. Boy, special teams play tonight has been ugly. 12 yards on the kick. Coming up next on ESPN, it is Notre Dame taking on BYU, and that game is in Provo. The Fighting Irish opening the season against the Cougars of Brigham Young.
See the education of quarterback Brady Quinn of Notre Dame. 9 touchdown passes last year, 15 interceptions. I expect him to be a lot better with the year's experience.
Boy, great, great. How many times, this is what, 3 times that Oregon State has taken the ball over on the LSU side of the 50-yard line. Wright finally hemmed up after a gain of about 5 to around the 41-yard line. Ron Franklin, Mike Gottfried, and Aaron Andrews coming to you from Tiger Stadium in Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Number 3-ranked LSU not off to a good start. They fumbled the opening kickoff and gave it to the Beavers at the 25. Beavers wound up scoring on that drive, made it 6-0, missed the extra point. I tell you, they came right back and got an interception or another fumble. And because quarterback Anderson got a little bit greedy, threw a pass interception, so they wound up with no points. And that's how we stand at 6-0. Running play is going to be a couple of yards short as Melvin Oliver puts a stop on Dwight Wright.
I'm going to say it again. The field conditions definitely have hurt LSU more than Oregon State.
Explain why.
The speed. The one thing I was impressed with more than anything else in practice was the ability of all the defensive linemen, linebackers, second.
kick this one to the 35-yard line. It's third down. LSU shows blitz. And now here come flags in. And I think that maybe Oregon State might have had a delay of game.
Good ball. False start.
Nope, false start. Beg your pardon.
On the offense. 5 yards. Remains third down.
Reese Davis, let's check back with you.
Okay, Ron, and we'll check in once again in Starkville, Tulane, and Mississippi State. Bullies up 7-0. Omar, Connor, Eric, Butler. Sylvester Kroom's team on top 14-0 in the third.
So an impressive start so far for Mississippi State. Third down. And now they're still going to go to the 35, so it's third down, and let's call it 8. Anderson, boy, gets hit, loses the ball, and I believe it's been recovered by LSU, and it has Marcus Spears.
Well, Ron, you talk about not being fast. Marcus Spears just became fast. It hit Derek Anderson on the backside. Here's Spears right here, coming to 84, beating the block. A nine house, causing the fumble, and then alertly trying to get on it. Spears, he beat the block and the tackle, and we talked about they have to protect Derek Anderson because the pass is the weapon.
Surprising that Anderson did not feel that bore since it was in his face. So LSU now with the first and 10 at their own 47. Randall, play action, got a man wide open if he can get it to him, and that ball is overthrown. I mean, early Doucette had two steps on the defensive back when he broke back toward the post.
Yeah, early Doucette is going to break to the outside and then the inside. He got Mitch Musin turned. Just threw it over his hands.
We got a flag down, and I'm not sure it would have mattered. I think we got another holding call on Whitworth.
Randall is so anxious.
And hold number 76 on the offense, 10 yards from the previous spot. Repeat first down.
Well, Swancutt is giving him fits.
Oh, he really is. And the offensive line of LSU is a strength. Whitworth, 6'7", 325-pound junior, and Ben Wilkerson, the center, 6'4", 297, are All-American candidates. Swancutt is bringing his A-game, which he always brings to the table.
Start to say, that's the thing that the coaches say that they love about him, is the fact that it never changes. The work ethic is there in practice. The work ethic is there in the ballgame. Three penalties now against the Tigers. First down at about 20. Benson has 5, has 10. He's open. Inside the 35-yard line, Eric Williams finally makes the tackle. And he finally got a little crease. And that's all that Justin Benson needs, 31 yards on that running play.
When they all of a sudden it spread out Oregon State's defense and hit the run inside with Justin Benson. 1,000 yards last year, 10 touchdowns.
Had the big run to open the game down at the Sugar Bowl in the national championship. Almost went the distance.
64-yard run.
Yep. Good block that time by Ben Wilkerson, the senior out of Hipville, Texas, to the senior center. Well, Vincent this time hit behind the line of scrimmage. And that is a dandy play by Jeff Van Orso, a redshirt freshman from Las Vegas. That's a pretty good job there. He comes in replacing Swancutt, who gets a breather, and he winds up with a tackle for a loss.
Yeah, it's real important depth-wise for the Beavers because they don't have a lot of defensive linemen. Swancutt, most of the time, is going to play the whole game.
Will Arnold, who was the newcomer on the offensive line, at guard, a redshirt freshman, number 73, is just hobbled off the field. And we'll try to get a report on him. Terrell McGill comes in replacing him. That pass is complete out in the far flat. Greg Davis makes the catch. And is going to be pushed out at the 25-yard line.
Jimbo Fisher, the offensive coordinator, talked about Marcus Randall, and he said once he knew he was a guy, he studied more film, prepared himself to go in this football game, And you talked about fifth-year guy. He's been around this program a lot of practices. He knows the offense.
So as we saw them checking over Arnold on the sideline, Shane Gang there tried to get things squared away on the far side. Joe Adai has checked in, number 10. And he is out to the right. I don't know if somebody took off running or what, but it's in they messed up the chain, and they were trying to get him down and keep somebody from getting hurt when the play came in their direction. And that's the reason for the delay right here. Okay, we're set to go. Third down. And they need about 3.5 yards. Tigers have not converted a third down situation tonight. Gets his pass away, and it is incomplete. Very nearly intercepted. Early Doucette, the intended receiver, and Musin was very close to picking it off.
Pretty good pass protection, but Marcus Randall, you're going to see the protection first of all. He blocked Swan Cut that time, Andrew Whitworth. Marcus Randall got hit, but threw it in the crowd. That's almost like putting it up for grabs and saying, I hope we get it.
So Chris Jackson to attempt a 42-yard field goal. Got enough leg on this one, but again, wide right. Well, some of the crowd getting a little anxious. A few scattered boos there. 2 minutes and 38 seconds left until halftime. Still 6-0, Oregon State.
In summarization, there are two main reasons to sign up for Net Zero. Internet access for $9.95 and high speed for just $5 more. Sign up and Net Zero will make a donation to Ronald McDonald House Charities. In summarization, there are three main reasons to sign up for Net Zero.
Now for a limited time, sign up for Net Zero and we'll make a donation to Ronald McDonald House Charities.
The itching and burning of athlete's foot. This is the latest way to get rid of it. This isn't. Lotrimin Ultra, the latest prescription strength medicine available without a prescription. So powerful, one use a day is all you need. Lotrimin Ultra.
From Philips comes the only flat TV with built-in ambient light technology, which changes color with whatever you're watching, so you are completely surrounded by the experience. A new Philips flat TV with Ambilight.
Michael, I need someone to work late tonight. I know it's after 5, and I know you probably have plans. By the way, you smell really good. Thank you.
Introducing Red Zone Body Wash from Old Spice. With 8-hour scent technology, the great smell lasts all day, whether you want it to or not.
Yeah, you do smell good.
New Red Zone Body Wash.
Well, 6-0, 2:38 left until halftime. You can see some of those threatening skies off in the distance. If you have joined us late, we had quite a deluge here. In fact, the game was held up for close to 50 minutes. That's how late we were getting started because of thunder, lightning, and heavy rain. And the situation, Oregon State has taken care of business, and the LSU Tigers have not so far. Anderson, 13-24, one interception for 115 yards and one touchdown. Keep this one on the ground, breaks off a tackle, that's right, and he's open at midfield at the 35 and is now going to be knocked out of bounds all the way down at the 26-yard line. Jesse Daniels makes the stop, and it's a 49-yard run.
Ron, I think it was a trap up inside with the guard pulled, and they trapped. Let's see. No, zone play that they broke backside. Dwight Wright just shows great speed and runs away from Corey Webster.
That's a career long run. Ryan Cole checks. send a tailback replacing Wright. And Anderson wants to throw on first down. Puts it up way, way, way overthrown. And Reese Davis, let's check with you.
Okay, Ron, coming up on the Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report, Trev and Mark are here. We'll talk about the double overtime thriller in the other Death Valley. Sylvester Crew making his debut. We'll also look ahead to our other game in primetime, Notre Dame and BYU. You guys finish up the first half. We'll see you in just a little bit.
Okay.
Ron, Derek Anderson has to not make a mistake here. He's got to come away with some points. Picked off a couple times, and
well, he's got the opportunity, and he's got to take advantage of it. Is what you're talking about. Is Dwight Wright tries to cut it back and take it to the open side of the field. Jesse Daniels is right there.
We talked about Oregon State's depth on defense and the offensive line. LSU right now looks to be a tired defense.
I kind of felt as though that on that long run just a moment ago was one of those things. Well, we're here close to halftime, but somebody's going to get him. But all of a sudden, poof, he's gone and does flip the field, just like you said. Packers show blitz. They come right up the middle, and the pass incomplete. Mel Oliver coming with pressure. In fact, they had dropped Marcus Spears off into coverage. And he was pretty close to it, along with Lionel Turner.
Melvin Oliver, number 90, is going to get right in there. Anderson never had a chance.
And he never should have thrown this football.
Got away with it.
So the field goal attempt is coming.
This is big.
They're going to place it down at the 30-yard line, so a 40-yard attempt right in the middle of the field. Cerna. He's got the distance, and he's good. 1:35 left until halftime, and our new score, Oregon State, 9-0.
Since its launch in 2002, the SEC's education initiative has grown to reach over 1.5 million children, with over 2,000 schools utilizing this interactive software as part of their daily curriculum.
Students love it, and research proves that it will increase test scores. Every school should be using Kids College.
Motivation is a key to learning, and SEC Kids College is a proven success. The universities of the Southeastern Conference, equipping tomorrow's leaders today.
It took a great game plan to bring the LSU Tigers to a national championship. But here's a look at LSU's other winning game plan. LSU has a great game plan on and off the field.
So we are back in Baton Rouge, 9-0 now, Oregon State, huge underdogs in this ballgame. And Mike, this does just wonders for them as far as going in at intermission time.
It really does, Ron. Derek Anderson's feeling good about himself. LSU really needs a big special teams kickoff return here. They got to get on the board here before half. We need the special teams to help them.
Well, Scott Green, one of the deep men back there, along with Joe Adai. Here's the kick. This is very short, and it's one of those quick spinners. On the run, the ball is fumbled. He'll just knock it out of bounds, which is a smart thing to do. Joe Adai, the ball very high, and kicked at an angle.
Oregon State doing a good job, Ron, hanging around here. Offensively, Anderson's been good in the first half. They've run the ball a little bit more the second quarter against a tired defense. When you have to rush the passer so many times, you tire out a little bit. Swan Cut has been unable to, they can't block him. The corners, Brandon Browner and Eric Williams, line up. They're taking away the two outside receivers, letting it be a nine-man defensive game.
Well, the LSU's defense has already played 39 snaps in the first half. Screen pass. Vincent going to make short yardage out of it as Bray again comes up to make the tackle. Keith Ellison is there to help out as well. Going to be a gain of about five, and the clock runs at 118, now 117. Randall, pressure is on, and he just throws this one away.
Smattering of boos, and they forgot the national championship already. But Marcus Randall, when you sit around a program for 5 years and you wait your turn, you have to have some good things happen to you. I like the way he practiced, though. He practiced hard. He looked like he was confident. But Oregon State's defense has done a great job of boxing up this offense.
Third down. They need to take it to the 34-and-a-half-yard line to keep this one going. And this pass right here going to be overthrown, way overthrown.
And see, the more you boo the quarterback and his teammates, doubt enters into this in the playing field. You've got to give a guy more time than this. Marcus Randall can get the job done. He just needs to settle down, needs some help.
Chris Jackson, only the second time that he would have punted, and Bernard is the deep man. Pressure up the middle, end over end is the kick. Very returnable. Makes the grab, and he'll take it to around the 47-yard line before the tackle is made. Coming up with the half, it's the Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report. Sylvester Croom in his debut, doubled overtime up at Clemson, and Notre Dame and BYU will have a preview of that.
Oregon State, 44 seconds, three timeouts. A lot of time for a passing team. If you're Mike Riley, do you take a chance on throwing the ball down the field here?
His quarterback is a cat with not nine lives anymore. He should have had four picked off, so I'm not sure I would gamble, no.
Yeah, he's buying your strategy.
Tackle is made. Inbounds by Corey Webster.
I think Mike Riley is doing exactly
smart
like
play.
Ron Franklin said. He's relaxed right now. He's got the lead. He's up by two scores. He's going to take it to the locker room and talk it over.
See what he just said. He
let's
gave
go
him
to the locker room.
Hands flat there, and he said, "Fellas, let's head to the locker room, talk it over. We got a 9-0 lead in a ball game that everyone told us we were crazy to play." Let's go down to Aaron on the sideline with Coach Roddy. Aaron.
All right, Ron, thanks so much. I'm here right now with Oregon State Coach Mike Riley. Coach, your defense has managed to keep LSU off the scoreboard. How do they keep that momentum going into the second half?
Well, that's going to be the key. You know, this is a long game. College football lasts a long time, so we're going to have to really keep playing good football. We got to take care of the ball offensively better and take advantage of opportunities. But, you know, it's just going to be a long, good half. We're going to have to come out ready to play like we did at the start.
You take a 9-point lead into the locker room against the co-defending national champs. What do you say to your team in there before they head back out?
Let's go have fun. Let's go play this second half for the time of our lives. That's what we're going
to do. Coach, thanks. Ron, back up to you.
Okay, Aaron, so our score at halftime, a shocker here in Baton Rouge, Oregon State, 9-0. Now here's Reese Davis with the Pontiac Halftime Report. Reese.
All right, Ron, in as difficult a place as Tiger Stadium is to play in, great atmosphere and everything, LSU hasn't won every home game in a season since 1972. They always seem to stumble. The loss last year was at home against Florida. Marcus Randall separated himself during fall practice, and you don't want to overreact with the bad weather and everything. How seriously do you consider going to Jamarcus Russell?
Well, I think that Nick Saban has to make that decision at halftime, obviously, but I think he has to seriously consider it and consider it early, because you've got an opportunity here to get your quarterback in there, your second teamer, right off the bat, get his feet wet in this situation, and start with a rhythm. They haven't had any rhythm at all offensively. You've got to do something to this Oregon State defense. Run it, pass it, have some type of success. They've not done that yet.
See, I'm looking at Oregon State's defense. I mean, for all the talk that we heard about LSU and their defense, how about Mark Banker
linebacker, the defensive coordinator at Oregon State, Bill Swancutt. I love kids that play 100% every single play. I think it's time to give a little credit to Oregon State, getting a lot of pressure on the quarterback, playing very well, and doing pretty good against the run. Very important against LSU.
You've got very good cornerbacks, too.
Yes,
Brandon Browner and Eric Williams at Oregon State. They've been able to do a good job on the outside. Well, the headline game in the SEC is in Starkville, where Sylvester Crooms, becoming the first African-American head coach in the SEC, making his game debut with the Bulldogs against Tulane. Crooms' team scoreless at halftime early in the second half after a turnover. Jarius Norwood cashes in. Bulldogs up 7-0. Sort of opened the floodgates just a little for Omar Connor, who finds Eric Buffer.
That's a nice job of pass check, getting your quarterback out of the pocket. But the first time they score, they do it on the ground. The second time through the air, just builds confidence in your quarterback and your offense.
14-0, new coach for Mississippi State, and new coach, new offense for Nebraska. And I know Western Illinois won double A. Joe Daly has looked terrific with four touchdown passes.
He may be the all-time leading passer in Nebraska history already. I'm not sure.
He probably threw more passes there than Eric Crouch did in an entire season, perhaps. We continue on the Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report. We'll tell you about some first impressions, some by a freshman, some sluggish performances. And speaking of freshmen, how about the guy in Georgia who did something even Herschel couldn't do? And we'll also talk about the impact of replay in a bit.
That is sweet.
My pride and joy.
Oh, it looks new.
Like right out of the showroom.
Oh, that is one great looking...
Whoa, hold on, honey. I'm showing Tom the floor.
Nice floor, Joan.
Make your garage floor the envy of the neighborhood. You can do it yourself with Rust-Oleum Epoxy Shield Garage Floor Coating. After prep, you're ready to go. Simple as painting a wall. Easy to clean and resists chipping and peeling. This all-inclusive kit is available at home centers, hardware stores, and automotive retailers near you. And now, transform your unfinished basement with Epoxy Shield Basement Floor Coating.
Are you okay?
My girlfriend dumped me. She says I'm too analog.
I can fix that.
So with your computer, an MP3 player, and this Napster download card, you're set.
And that's it? That's easy.
David?
It's digital music made easy at Best Buy. Thousands of possibilities. Get yours.
The laughter and the tears, the shadows of misty yesteryears, the good times and the...
How do the Bears shut down Brett Favre?
Boom, don't worry, that's not going to happen.
What's this, the Tokyo subway? You guys are stepping all over each other. All right, from the top.
Sunday NFL Countdown, the hardest working pregame show in football, begins September 12th.
04 Crew Cap 21-888. 04 Trailblazer 18-988. It's gonna be the big month of trucks at Brian Harris Chevy. Over 200 Chevy trucks and SUVs marked for clearance. Crew Cab LS AC Automatic Power Package, 21-888. 04 Trailblazer LS AC Automatic Power Package, 18-988. It's the big month of trucks at Brian Harris Chevy, Florida, east of Flannery.
When you're thinking about buying a diamond, how do you know if you're getting the best, most beautiful diamond for your money? Lane's Jewelry travels overseas to the world's diamond cutting center in Antwerp, Belgium.
Hi, I'm Lane from Lane's Jewelry. Buying directly from the cutter gives me the ability to pick from some of the world's finest diamond inventories.
You can be confident that you're getting the very best diamond for your money. Stop by Lane's Jewelry in Gonzales today.
The Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report is powered by Pontiac and the first ever G6, the next official performance machine of the NCAA.
I think you've seen this weekend's best performance on the field. Catch College Game Day final Saturday night to see the Pontiac game-changing performance. We'll run down the biggest plays of the day, and you'll get the chance to pick each week's winner. College Game Day final presented by Pontiac. Saturday nights all season long. Perhaps an entire changing performance for the Oklahoma offense coming
the hands of a freshman, Adrian Peterson. They might not have had a back around Norman quite like Peterson, the freshman going 35 yards against Bowling Green. Sooners roll 40-24, though sluggish at times. Oklahoma able to take care of business. We will see Notre Dame and BYU a little bit later on tonight. That will be after the Oregon State and LSU game. Another game going on in the top 25. But Kansas State is struggling with Western Kentucky. The Hilltoppers giving the Wildcats fits, although Darren Sproles has 71 yards in the first half.
And Danny Ware, Reese. Danny Ware, true freshman at Georgia, now complete offense, 123 yards rushing, and three touchdowns on the day. Got to work on the defense a little bit, but Georgia rolls.
48-28 the final, and Ware starts the first game as a true freshman, something a Georgia tailback hadn't done since the 40s. Herschel didn't even do that, although Dewey got Herschel in that opening game against Tennessee. Auburn against Louisiana Monroe. Cadillac Williams bust 100 yards for the 12th time in his career, and the new Al Borges offense under Tommy Tuberville puts 31 on UL Monroe in a shutout win. Auburn's got Mississippi State next. Miami, Ohio, and Michigan, the Redhawks had the longest winning streak in the nation at 14 straight, but the freshman, Chad Henne, seeing a lot of freshmen, finding Braylon Edwards for the touchdown. Michigan then converted a bunch of turnovers into an avalanche of points, 43-10. Henne starting because Matt Gutierrez, who is named starter for Michigan, came down with a sore arm during the week. Ohio State challenged by Mark D'Antonio's Bearcats for a while, but Lydell Ross goes over 100 yards, and Ohio State beats Cincinnati 27-6. Elsewhere in the Big Ten, UCF, University of Central Florida, against Wisconsin. Now, this is Dontez Sanders, who grabs the fumble. This was an example of how Big Ten used instant replay.
Magnificent job here. They stopped the game. They called this play back. It was a great job of instant replay. 90 seconds is all it took.
To get it right, they got the fumble right, they got the down right, and then Anthony Davis with the run here. It took them nearly 5 minutes. They reviewed this play to see where he stepped out of bounds. It was as if we got a microcosm of replay, the very best it could be and the very worst it could be in a very short span, but Wisconsin rolled 34-6.
I don't want to talk about that. I want to talk about Iowa. 39-7. Drew Tate played well. How about Kirk Ferentz, another quarterback developing him? He left the game with some muscle cramps. He should be okay. Iowa looked good against Kent State.
Now, Drew Tate with the dehydration. Iowa rolling 39-7, able to move on. Cal 56-14. J.J. Arrington went for a buck 81 and three touchdowns, averaged over 11 yards per carry. Virginia, I know Temple's not strong. They had an awful season last year, but Virginia looked very crisp, very sharp. Wally Lundy over 100 yards and admitted he was a little nervous. They played that game in Philadelphia. He's from a nearby town in New Jersey. Once he settled down, he had an outstanding afternoon. Tyrone Willingham and the Fighting Irish open their season later tonight on ESPN against BYU. We'll take you out to Provo to get you ready in just a bit.
Project your best, only at the Home Depot. This Labor Day weekend at the Home Depot and Expo, get no payments, no interest for 12 months on any purchase store-wide of $2.99 or more with your Home Depot or Expo consumer credit card. And now through Monday only, get $5 off all 1 gallon cans of Behr paints, stains, and waterproofers. You can start and finish your last summer project right. Only at the Home Depot. You can do it. We can help.
Doesn't rewind. So if your child is drinking and smoking pot, stop them while you still can.
Jessica, we need to talk.
There's help.
Welcome back to the Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report.
Well, any coach at Notre Dame always faces pressure, but the Fighting Irish are 5-9 over their last 14 games. They haven't lost 10 out of 15 in any stretch since the 60-61 seasons. It wasn't long after that the Fighting Irish changed coaches, Eric Parsegian, arriving on the scene. Tyrell Willingham, however, believes that his club is on the verge of something big. Something big will have an opportunity to get started tonight in Provo, Utah against BYU. That's where our Dave Barnett will lead the team and call the game later tonight.
Reese, thanks. It was 20 years ago today that Lavelle Edwards and BYU began their march to the 1984 National Championship by beating Pittsburgh. That team is being honored here this weekend in Provo, where the latest edition prepares to host Notre Dame next up following the action in Baton Rouge. However, the recent headlines here have not all involved the happiness of looking back at 20 years ago or the expectations of what begins tonight. Rather, they have involved off-season headlines, allegations of sexual assault on August 8th, possibly involving a number of Cougar football players. Provo police concluded their investigation Tuesday. No charges have been filed. BYU, meanwhile, is conducting a review aimed at determining whether its honor code was violated. That's the code which, among other things, prohibits alcohol consumption and premarital sex. All this after two other off-season, off-field incidents which have led to the dismissal of a total of six Cougar football players. With that background, we do expect one of the biggest crowds in the history of Lavelle Edwards Stadium and an outstanding opener. Two very hopeful programs, Notre Dame and BYU, coming up. Reese, back to you.
All right, Dave, we'll look forward to seeing the Fighting Irish and the Cougars in just a little while. See if Croton is able to get that offense going. Just a couple years ago, they led the nation in total offense. They were down in the bottom 15 in the country or so last year. Yes, it has not been pretty. We will continue on the Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report in just a little bit. Oregon State, Derek Anderson finding George Gillette. Hey, the Tigers may be in for a close shave. It's 9-0 Beavers.
Multitasking is great, except when you're driving. Answer the cell phone, referee the kids in the back seat, drink your coffee. We all do it. But Allstate knows if you do it a little less, you're less likely to have an accident or get a ticket. Keep a safe record and Allstate can save you up to 20%. Safe drivers cost everyone less. They should pay less. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
There's more to protecting your family in the summertime than knowing which sunscreen to use. You've got to make sure they're protected at home as well. And no one helps protect families better than ADT. Call now and take advantage of ADT's summer special. Get your first 2 months of monitoring free and up to 20% off your homeowner's insurance. You may even qualify for zero-down financing for installation. But you better hurry. Let ADT make this the safest summer ever. ADT, always there.
About my buying experience at Duplessis Cadillac was the sales personnel. They were wonderful.
My experience with Duplessis Cadillac over the past several years has been top draw. You could not ask for a better service department in this city.
Right now, save $12,000 on any 04 Cadillac DeVille in stock and get 0% financing on 04 Cadillac Escalades. But hurry, the sale ends September 7th. The dream becomes a reality at Duplessis Cadillac.
For over 75 years, our customers have been coming from all over South Louisiana to buy their cars, trucks, and SUVs. No matter where you bought your vehicle, we'll treat you with the kindness, respect, and courtesy that all our customers have come to love. It's a tradition that started with my grandfather, and that's how we've been doing business ever since. So come visit us in the Pornville, and remember, no matter where you are, all roads lead to Bogart's.
The Pontiac High Performance Halftime Report is powered by Pontiac. Vote for this week's Pontiac game-changing performance at ESPN.com/Pontiac.
Boy, there was a thriller in the other Death Valley today. Clemson outlast Wake Forest 37-30 in double overtime. Charlie Whitehurst, his sixth career 300-yard passing game. Bowden had a couple of 100-yard receivers in Aries Curry and Chancey Stuckey. So Clemson off to a 1-0 start. LSU in a world of trouble in their version of Death Valley. The Beavers done the only scoring in the first half. Second half coming, Oregon State up 9.
Take it over at the 20-yard line. So, Mike, halftime. Coach Saban, what do you say to your co-defending national champions after that first half performance?
Well, first of all, the national championship is last year. So I would tell them that it's a four-quarter football game. We got to make some things happen on defense. Offensively, I think that if they settle down, I still believe Marcus Randle. I think you got to give him more time in here. And I think you got to spread the field out, run the ball, take your shots downfield against the inside receiver, against the linebackers.
You know, it may have to be the defense that brings this crowd back into the football game, quite frankly.
Make a big play and then get them right back in this.
Anderson lobs it out, has it complete to his tight end. That's Newton, and he is going to be tackled by Landry. Tonight's first half stats brought to you by Rust-Oleum Epoxy Shield.
Well, when you look at LSU, Ron, it's very, 93 total yards, but 39 passing yards, and that's not good. When you got sleep a little bit with the open attack like they have.
Jamarcus Russell warming up down on the sideline. I don't know if this means that he's coming in on his opening series. I would be surprised if he did. But anyway, he is loosening on the sideline. Pass incomplete. Oh, what a hit. Newton took it. Pretty good shot there by Travis Daniels.
You talk about coming out to play in the third quarter. The defense, two plays, two pretty good hits. Now they need to stop this third down, get the ball back, and be in business. Now this is going to be an interesting decision. I think you got to go longer with Randle. We'll see what Nick Saban chooses to do.
Third down. Line to make is the 30. Anderson going to run it. Under heavy pressure, going to be knocked down short of the first down. In fact, he's knocked down behind the line of scrimmage, and it's Kirsten Pittman who made the tackle.
Well, your defense did exactly what you wanted them to do if you're Nick Saban. They set the tempo for the start of the third quarter. Now the offense has to feed off of it.
LSU stands back to kick. It's his fourth punt.
I believe Jamarcus Russell is coming into the game.
Wow. I'm surprised. Skyler Green, the deep man, has dropped off to the 35. They're coming after him, and here's the kick, his best of the night. Wobbly spiral, the turnover, and here he comes from the 32. Pushed out of bounds at around the 40, so good start position for the LSU Tigers. And Mike, here he comes, the big freshman out of Mobile, Alabama. And listen to this crowd.
Ron, I've been watching this young man since he was a freshman in high school. And he has all the talent in the world. He can be as good as he wants to be.
Now, the difficult thing for Jimbo Fisher, the offensive coordinator, is you got to nurture him a little bit in play calling also against a very tough defense at Oregon State.
When you make that switch and you tell Marcus Randle you didn't do the job, you still have to, if this guy doesn't work out, Jamarcus, you got to go back to Marcus Randle. So you got to coach him up. Here's Marcus Randle, the interception, which was costly early in the football game, gets pressure, throws the ball out of bounds, just heaves it out of bounds. You know, it just looked like he lost confidence in the second quarter.
Yep, sure did. And staring down receivers as well. Russell zings it. The ball is tipped and almost intercepted. And boy, that's Keith Ellison, the strong side linebacker who got a hand on it.
Everybody likes the second team quarterback, but it's what happens around the quarterback also. Receivers, young receivers, we talked about it, USC. Liner did not look good in the first half. Came on the second half and hit some big passes to preserve that win.
Well, LSU now, third down situation. They are 0 of 7 in third down conversions tonight. They need to take it to the 50-yard line. Russell, here comes blitz, gets by the first man, gets by the second, and throws this one away. And heavy pass pressure by Trent Bray.
A new quarterback, you're going to blitz him. Trent Bray, the linebacker, coming in. They moved him out of the pocket, got him on the move. And Jamarcus shows you great athletic ability to throw that ball away.
Third punt by this young man, Chris Jackson. High pass, but he brings it down. And his best kick of the night. Hanging spiral. Fair catch is called for and made at the 21 by Bernard. 40 yards and a kick. We'll take a break. 12:27 left in the third. It's still 9-0.
I'm here for my massage. These big muscles need some tenderizing.
Okay, cutie. Room 5.
Thank you.
You're here for the body treatment?
Oh, yeah. My body, your treatment?
Okay. Let's go.
Okay.
Fresh, smooth, real Bud Light.
Is there a breeze in here?
It's all here. Fresh, made to order. Sonic's got it, others don't. At Sonic, you won't find any microwaves around here, but you will find delicious all-beef burgers served with the freshest ingredients around and made after you order them, the way you like them. It's not just good, it's Sonic good.
The Beast. Smarter. Stronger. Tougher. It's time for everyone else to play catch-up again.
From Philips comes the only flat TV with built-in ambient light technology, which changes color with whatever you're watching, so you are completely surrounded by the experience. The new Philips flat TV with Ambilight.
A big reason for me coming back was, you know, obviously to come back and get a degree. I just thought about after football, and I want to be somewhere at a big office, at a skybox office, looking over the city, really sitting back and doing business. Education is the only thing that is guaranteed. It's the only thing. When you have a degree, no one can take that away from you. NCAA football, a lifetime of opportunity.
Back on campus, and this week in Baton Rouge, Louisiana, some of the faithful that have traveled down here from the state of Oregon. That's attractive, but I'm not sure you need that kind of warmth on a night like this. I wouldn't want to be sitting close to him anyway. So Derek Anderson, who injured his passing hand right at the end of the first half, back in the ballgame. You look at his numbers, 6 of 7 to start, 8 of 21 since then. And they keep it on the ground. There's nothing doing here. Kyle Williams. Okay, Kyle has really done a superb job tonight. We have called his name a lot.
LSU is winning the battle at the line of scrimmage in the second half. Penetration. You talked about Kyle Williams coming through, making the play, a 6'2", 295-pound junior. The defense knows it's up to them right now to get this game turned around. Force a turnover or force bad field position.
They go with a run again, and this is going to be for almost no yards. It'll be third down and 10-plus. Clyde Roten in there to Claude Roten, I should say, in there to make the tackle for LSU. Williams, who has had such a good night, trying to replace Chad Lavallee, the outstanding defensive tackle who graduated this past year.
Chad Lavallee, he was like a guy like Swancutt that would play every play like it was a national championship game.
Third down. They need to take it to the 32. Pressure from behind, gets it away, and that ball is almost intercepted, and gets who? Kyle Williams was all over the back of the ball carrier, and he had a shot at picking that off. Corey Webster
Christmas Eve series for the Tigers.
Muscue to punt, fifth time that he would have taken care of those chores tonight. LSU's got the return on good hanging spiral. And Scott Green's going to let it go, and it'll go out of bounds around the 37-yard line. So we'll take a break. 10:57 left, third quarter. Oregon State continues to lead 9-0.
I can't believe it's been 25 years. Time flies when you're having fun. Good luck for the next 25 years. And tip of the hat from all us Bear fans.
They set up in the eye on this, the last play of the game. And here's the snap. Hand off to the tailback. Peterson tries the right side. Wow, what a hit. But he stays on his feet, and he's broken to the outside, and it's wide open. Touchdown. Give him a touchdown.
Beast. Smarter. Stronger. Tougher. It's time for everyone else to play catch-up again.
Multitasking is great. Except when you're driving. Answer the cell phone, referee the kids in the back seat, drink your coffee. We all do it. But Allstate knows if you do it a little less, you're less likely to have an accident or get a ticket. Keep a safe record and Allstate can save you up to 20%. Safe drivers cost everyone less. They should pay less. That's Allstate, Stan. Are you in good hands?
ESPN's College Football Saturday Primetime, brought to you by Russell Athletic, who has proudly outfitted 34 national championship football teams. Are you Russell material? And the next Ford Super Duty, tougher, stronger, smarter.
Anderson on the far sideline, toweling off. Very wet and muddy out there on that field. And of course, imperative that a quarterback keep his hands as tidy as you possibly can. Keep them clean. Jamarcus Russell, his second consecutive series. Play action, and they're going to throw the bubble screen, and a dive will come back and pick it up to make sure that it was not a backward pass.
Jamarcus Russell, 6'5", 248 pounds, is a high school phenom over in Mobile, Alabama. Was a highly recruited quarterback, came down to Florida, LSU, as Marcus Randall waits for another chance.
Ali Broussard comes into the ballgame. First time we've seen him, sophomore out of Lafayette. Outstanding, very strong tailback. Bad snap, and they fight over the football. Jamarcus Russell running for his life, and now is going to be hit from behind and tackled at around the 31-yard line. Keith Ellison on the stop. What was the snap? Just come low?
Came low. Ron, if he doesn't hit this pass, I think you have to go back to Randall. He's more experienced.
See Ben Wilkerson going for a towel there, the big offensive centers. You look at the Marcus Randall, who was the starter in tonight's ball game on the sideline.
Hey, this about Jamarcus Russell. He's an athlete, and he's calm and cool. Even though he didn't play last year, 0-for-3 here at the start, he's not going to get riled up. Pretty confident young man.
Third down. That was a little bit low on that snap. Throws it up the sideline, got a man, and he just led him a little too much, Craig Davis.
The offense just can't get anything going. These three passing attempts there, they got to go back to the run game because the offensive line is a strength. The running backs are a strength, even though you got that guy, Swan, cut on the other side. You got to spread them out and run the football.
Chris Jackson to kick again. His longest of the night, 42. You see his average just over 38. Fair catch is called for and made at around the 35-yard line by Bernard. Well, last year in New Orleans, actually this year, because it was after the first, Justin Benson on the first play from scrimmage makes it 64 yards. He had 117 yards rushing against Oklahoma and was the MVP of that ball game. Meanwhile, the Tiger defense held Oklahoma in check. Marcus Spears with the interception here, and he'll take it in for the touchdown. LSU won its first national championship in 45 years with a 21-14 victory over Oklahoma. This pass out in the flat by Anderson is caught by Haynes and then pushed out of bounds. And the trophy is there on the sidelines tonight.
And, Ron, we've seen both these teams. USC last week struggled in the first half, came back and won the football game. Reggie Bush had a big outing in that game. Liner got hot late in the game. LSU still can win this football game. Defense has got control of Oregon State's offense at this point. We still question whether Derek Anderson has a hand injury or not.
Third down and five. Oregon State has missed their last six third down situations. Still blitz, and here they come. It's a quarterback draw, and he goes right down. Kyle Williams with another tackle.
Takes a while in a football game when you're blitzing team to get to cadence. Now, that may have been a delay a game call. You get another play.
Against the offense, 5 yards, repeat third down.
Where that flag appeared, Mike Riley gets another chance. But LSU has timed up the starting count. Their blitz is hitting the right areas.
Sir Henry Anderson was injured, went to the locker room. May have been cramps.
Drinking.
Injured. He's drinking a lot of fluid there. He is the starter, great defensive tackle, so good to see him back out on the field.
The go-to receiver is Haas right here on the inside. Mike Haas.
Third down. Got to take it to the 45. Anderson. Incomplete. Gillette. And boy, he was covered completely by Corey Webster.
Did not throw that ball very well either. Derek Anderson. Slipped out of his hand. Defense did their job again.
Pulescu, six times that he has kicked this evening. High, high, good coverage kick. Skyler Green signals for a fair catch and makes it at the 21. 44 yards in the boot. We'll go away for a minute. 9-0 Oregon State. 8:41 left in the third.
You have but one question.
Will Bill Callahan's West Coast offense resurrect the Cornhuskers?
Does a condor rise from his own ashes?
Do you mean a phoenix?
No second question.
ESPN College Game Day, built by the Home Depot. Saturdays at 10:30 on ESPN.
Oh, that's the way I like it.
Etouffee and shrimp creole, jambalaya and gumbo.
Oh, yeah.
Louisiana fish fry products makes it easy to serve your favorite Louisiana entrees.
Can't get enough.
The secret's in the seasoning, and the seasoning's in every package of entree and rice mix.
Aw, oh, now you're cooking.
Ready in less than 30 minutes. With Louisiana fish fry products, you got dinner down easy.
Oh, that's the way I like it.
He's put a lot of preparation into this moment. He sets up. Oh, he didn't see that one coming. But wait, he won't be denied. He's going for it. He may have it. Oh, let's see that again. Ooh, that's gotta hurt. He worked hard for that victory. Campus Federal, putting things within your reach.
So we're back 9-0, just about the midway point of the third quarter. Jamarcus Russell back in the ballgame. How long do you stay with him now, Mike?
Yeah, one more series, but he's got to get a chance to throw a deep ball at this point in the game. You've got to get these DBs off of you.
Alec Broussard at tailback. Quick out pass, and that one thrown a little too far in front of Scott Green.
What happens is the body language of the offense at this point, they've lost confidence and they want something to happen. That's why I say air one out, throw a long pass here and air one out, maybe get lucky.
Nick Saban continuing to pace and for good reason. Well, offensively it has just not been there so far this evening. Russell rolls out, throws this one complete out to the 28-yard line. It's Bo. Jonathan Pollard got out there to make the stop.
Flat route to Dwayne Bo, number 80. Well thrown by Jamarcus. Still big third down here. You got to pick it up.
Need to take it to the 31.5-yard line. You can see the yellow line. See if they can reach that juncture, and they do. A dive with the catch, and let's check in with Reese Davis. Reese.
All right, Ron, a historic night in the SEC. Sly Croom, the first African-American head coach in the conference, leading Mississippi State against Tulane. That's Darnell Jones going in for a little icing. State rolls over Tulane, 28-7, and when Sly least suspects it, the victory bath. Sly Croom, victorious in his first game. Jarius Norwood over 100 yards. And look at this, second half, Ole Miss trailing Memphis by 4.
Tell you what, Williams for Memphis is as good a running back as anybody has in the country. There's a dive, catching the pass, tough running. Wow, that'll garner a large amount of applause, and it does. He takes it to the 45 as Siegert finally wrestles him down.
Jimbo Fisher is real important right here. He's the offensive coordinator. He's doing things that Jamarcus is getting some confidence with. Short passes, there's a quick screen to Adai in the flat passes, and Jamarcus all of a sudden looks like he's getting in rhythm.
Alec Broussard continues to operate a tailback. They give it to him, and he's loose. Broussard down the far sideline, finally bumped out of bounds. Where do they say it? The 40-yard line by Scott.
Fresh legs coming into the football game. Show good speed as he breaks outside. Gets a handoff, gets a good block. Nate Livings.
Livings, yeah.
Livings, and off in the secondary.
Mike, I'll tell you something else about Broussard. He's not only strong because he's a big running back at 235, he's also the fastest of the running back. And that extra quick step got him outside. But your point about him having fresh legs. Also is well taken. Deep over the middle. Got his man. Did he hold on? Yes, and it's a dive.
A dive. Moved out to wide receiver. He's good hands. He's a great third down back and all. this crowd has got with the offense.
They'll go with the two tight end set. David Jones comes on. Keith Zinger, number 82 and number 89. Allie Broussard will come to the sideline. Justin Vincent, a tailback. They fake it to him. Looking for the end zone. Got a man out there, and he just threw it a little too far. Oh, that was Justin Vincent.
Had the right idea.
Yeah.
You like when the quarterback goes to the right receiver, just overthrew it. But he's got bounce in his step right now. The offensive line has a big bounce. They finally have figured it out that they can score.
Deepest drive of the night tonight. Oregon State's 18-yard line. This is the eighth play of the drive. Allie Broussard comes back into the lineup, number 22. They give it to Broussard. Puts a head down. Almost said the ball is loose, but it was a headgear that came flying out of there. I don't know if it belonged to Broussard or not. No, it's a beaver. Swan cut, I think, is one. Yep, that lost his headgear. May lose his headgear, but a young man won't lose his head. He is one steady ball player.
Ron, what we talked about at the beginning, the heat, humidity. Swan cut looks like a tired football player. He had one play off, but he has wore down. This is the first drive where they've had to stay on the field.
Third down, and they need to take it to the 8.5-yard line. Jamarcus Russell from a shotgun. Here comes the blitz right up the middle. They pick it up, lobs the pass, and he's got it. Touchdown, Scott Green. Saban happy with his decision. Marcus Randall was one of the first to Jamarcus Russell when he came off the sideline to shake his hand. That's a team effort. Exactly. I mean, it doesn't mean that there's a new sheriff in town, but it could mean that they just
needed
got the brasso out of the bottom drawer and they're going to start polishing it up. Chris Jackson will kick it off. Well, for the first time in a long time, this crowd is back in the ballgame. And, Mike, your point about the defense of Oregon State is huge. I mean, that's the longest, I believe, they've had to stay on the field all night long as far as number of plays and time off the clock.
This is about the time the heat kicks in.
Bernard and Cole, the two deep men. Near sideline, and it's going to be out of bounds. So Oregon State will take it over with good field position.
Now, Ron, Derek Anderson's got to answer. He's been two for the last 10 passes.
Only two passes over 10
since that
first drive, I think, Mike, is... Which means...
9 plays, 3 yards in the last 3 possessions. LSU's defense has really been the big spark. And now Derek Anderson's got to answer that score.
Ryan Cole will open up a tailback. LSU's corners come up to play bump at the line of scrimmage. And then inside, they play a little bump with the running back. It's going to be a very short game. Because of the rainstorm here earlier, the BYU-Notre Dame football game will start over on ESPN2 at 9:30. That's 9:30 Eastern time. As soon as this game is over, we will switch to the BYU-Notre Dame game back over to ESPN. 9:30 Eastern time, ESPN2. As soon as this one's over, it'll come over to ESPN. LSU shows blitz. Here they come off the corner. Flag is down. Now another.
Sets up before the rush can get to him. Hits Joe Newton, his tight end. Option route where he just turns away from the linebacker. Makes the catch.
Travis Daniels was the man who put the short tackle on him. If you look at the numbers on Anderson. Quite right, checks back in a tailback. Third down, line to make is the 45. Quick pass, missed the tackle. And Mike Cass is off and running. And boy, a huge mistake defensively. Did not keep him in front of him. And he allowed him to break the tackle. It's good for 28.
Yeah, Corey Webster, usually a very good tackler in the secondary, hits Mike Haas too high. He slips off. The uniform's wet. He slips right off. And Haas goes for extra yardage.
See, that would have been close to limiting to him to not picking up the first down. And then he winds up picking 19 more yards up. Running play. Hello, nothing. Wow. Claude Roten, the junior out of Bastrop, is there to make the hit.
I talked about the defensive line for Oregon State being a little tired. I think the offensive line, Claude Roten, came through scot-free to make that tackle.
About to go under 3 minutes remaining in this third quarter. 2-point game, Oregon State, 9-7. Good protection. Now runs up into the pocket. 35 at the 30. And stayed in bounds to get the hit. And Corey Webster kind of played off of him, thinking he'd be out of bounds. Didn't want to get the penalty.
Derek Anderson's hurt. He's a gamer. Limping onto the field.
First and 10, Oregon State trying to answer following that LSU touchdown. game tackle. First man there is Quali, the strong side linebacker.
I've been impressed with Derek Anderson. If he does have an injured hand, and that's the reason they're not throwing the ball deep, he has been a guy that you could tell his uniform. He has played this football game intelligently. He's had a couple interceptions that he didn't get picked off, but here's when the last play before, it looked like he got his hip.
Second down, swings this one out, and he's got it to Cole. Missed tackle, and Cole is going to pick up the extra yards and the first down. So poor tackling by LSU's defense on this series has been the difference.
All right, Ron, you're right. Starting Corey Webster too high, and on this play, Ryan Cole gets a little flare pass. Here's a missed tackle by Lionel Turner, second in tackles last season.
Mike, I was going to say, the two guys who have missed the tackles are two of the most sure tacklers on this LSU Tiger defense.
Good drive by the Beavers.
Ryan Cole, left side, cuts it back at the 5-yard line, and he's down to the 4. Dan Haynes with an excellent block on the play to kick the defender out.
We talked about early in the show that they were going to throw the ball and the run was going to set up the pass. Now they have more confidence in the run. Their offensive line really doing a pretty good job of run blocking.
Ninth play of the drive coming up. Clock continues to run. We're about to go under 60 seconds left in the third quarter.
Time. 1 second when he called the timeout.
So Anderson calls a timeout and it stops the clock at the 5:52 seconds, 52.3 actually, is what we have left in the third quarter.
Talked about Mike Riley choosing to play this football game.
ABC's Monday Night Football officially opens its 35th anniversary season as the Indianapolis Colts take on Super Bowl champion, the New England Patriots. It all happens Thursday night, September the 9th at 8 Eastern on ABC Sports Championship Television.
Well, Bill Belichick coaches the Patriots. Nick Saban, they were together at the Browns when Belichick was the head coach. Nick Saban was a secondary coach. Picked up a lot of this defense from Bill Belichick and also picked up from Jerry Glanville, who was the first guy to hire him. The pros, George Perlis, another guy with a pro background, taught Nick Saban.
Nick Saban said that he and Belichick talked pretty often on the telephone. So the situation here, Anderson saved a crucial 5 yards. They were about to get a delay of game. Called the timeout. And so the ball sitting just outside the 4-yard line. Second down, Beavers.
Just an A for his play calling on that drive. Missed tackles, as you said, but great play calling by Paul Christ.
Well, there's a flag down.
Think they're in the pros, they're going to keep the ball. Got to give it back.
Well, he He still got it.
Wheat Brown's going to say, you're not going to get this ball. He gave you 10 more yards.
Cerna to attempt the extra point, and this one moves back, as you can see, following the penalty. And he hit the upright again. Tell you what, he's been perfect. I mean, he nailed him square in the middle both times. 15-7.
That's big, Ron, because it's still an 8-point game. Here's the extra point. Malt. Wheat Brown cost him 5 yards to keep the football.
See, Mike, here's where his teammate cost him. Yeah. Because you could see the route that the ball is taking. It might have brushed the pole, but it wouldn't have come straight back.
5 yards
because of the angle.
The football.
That's right.
And a good drive by Derek Anderson. Nick Saban not real happy. He's getting on LaRon Landry and on the other side, the phone call.
Reese Davis, what do you have for us?
All right, Ron, checking in now. Bryant-Denny Stadium, Alabama and Utah State. Brody Croyle in a 24-10 game. Up top, looking for the freshman, Keith Brown. He hauls it in, but the Tide can't pull away from Utah State. 34-17, late third.
Well, you think about Alabama and Auburn. Both were failing on getting Jamarcus Russell out of the state of Alabama to go to school. LSU got him. They got a great player. His future is the highest high.
Here comes the kick. Line drive going to be taken at the two by Skyler Green. Gets to the outside. And will make it out to around the 32-yard line. We mentioned the high ankle sprain that he's getting over. Not his usual quick self, but still enough to help this football team. It's a return of 30.
Take his high ankle sprain in the wet field.
Yeah.
Slowed him down.
Anderson pacing on the far sideline.
Gutsy performance. Guy took a big hit on that run when he scrambled. Came back and led his team down the field for the touchdown.
So Jamarcus Russell, who led the Tigers to their first touchdown of the night, back in at quarterback. Takes it to Benson. Right over the middle, the ball is tipped and incomplete. A lot of white jerseys right there.
They're turning him loose. Jimbo Fisher knows the clock is going to become an important fact in this game, so he's got to turn him loose. Go upfield.
A reminder on the program note, BYU Notre Dame will kick off at 9:30 Eastern on ESPN2. And immediately following the conclusion of this one, the game will be moved over to ESPN where we are. Reversed the pass, got it there, and it's incomplete. Nice defensive play as Piscatelli got a hand on it.
Ron, he got beat for the touchdown, but he lays out on this play. Savvy Piscatelli. Watch him lay out, give effort against a die. That ball was in there.
That was
well thrown by Jamarcus Russell. Should have been caught.
Thrown across his body against the grain, and it was there. But also Piscatelli, as you said, by him laying out, that was just enough distraction.
Everything comes easy for Jamarcus Russell. You see why he's a great high school quarterback.
Third down, Tigers only 2 of 11 on third down conversions. Boy, that's a good pickup by Vincent on the block. Pass is tipped and incomplete. And that's Browner who came up to break up the pass.
Nick Saban wanted interference on Skyler Green, his wide receiver, from Browner. Browner is really an outstanding corner.
Very physical, yeah.
6'4", 202 pounds. Jimbo Fisher said he plays with an attitude.
Tell you, we need to also keep that last play and take a look at the job that Justin Vincent did on the blitz.
Oh,
he not only picked
job.
Him up, he destroyed the defender. Excellent job. Hanging spiral, going to barely turn over. And on the run, it is caught. And let's go back to Reese Davis.
All right, Ron, a game that many have tagged as a potential upset. Toledo and Minnesota. Minnesota driving the freshman fullback, Justin Valentine, taking it in rather than Lawrence Maroney or Marion Barber III. But Bruce Gradkowski had the answer for the Rockets, and it's Lance Moore, who led the nation in catches per game last year. Waltz is in. We're locked up at 7.
Okay, Reese, our situation, 15-7. Oregon State got the upset going right now with just under 12 seconds remaining in the third quarter. Wright gets the handoff.
Right turn ball.
Dorsey comes over to make the tackle on that one. And that's the end of the third quarter, so we'll take a timeout. Oregon State, a 3-touchdown underdog, is up by 8 as we head to the final 15.
ESPN, the magazine, on newsstands now.
Ford Expedition, the first to introduce all of the firsts. First-in-class safety canopy system. First-in-class independent rear suspension. First in its class for cargo room. And Ford Expedition is the first and only full-size SUV with the powerful third-row seat. Ford Expedition, the full-size SUV that's full of firsts. Ford Expedition.
Oh, what a beautiful morning. It's great to be alive. Strolling on the water.
For those who never quit. The battery that never quits. Energizer. Keep going.
All American brewed beers are fresh. What really matters is flavor. Let's see what happens when beer drinkers compare the flavor of Bud and Miller Genuine Draft.
It's a Budweiser town.
Okay, what beer do you drink?
Budweiser.
Do you want to do a taste challenge?
I do want to do a taste challenge.
And compare the color?
On the right has more color.
Tell me which one has more flavor.
This one has more flavor.
You picked.
I chose Miller Genuine Draft. I'm surprised.
You did not pick Budweiser.
You're kidding me. Kills me to say it, but Miller Genuine Draft has more flavor.
Taste for yourself. Miller, good call.
On DVD, the team's perfect plan.
Gentlemen, to us.
Just got ugly.
Well, this is Mountain Girl, and she helps me with everything.
Hey, you bought your to the Waffle Hut?
From the creators of Fargo.
I don't keep secrets. That's not how you maintain a loving relationship.
You bought your to the Waffle Hut.
The Lady Killers.
I will thank you to stop referring to Mountain that way. She is the other half of my life.
The man bought his to the Waffle Hut.
Own it this Tuesday on DVD.
6:57 from Baltimore.
You have a son?
7 o'clock.
7 o'clock. Want to get a bite? Bath time.
I've got you under my skin. I've got you.
Say hi.
Deep in my heart.
There's Dad.
Introducing free high-speed internet access in every room. Courtyard. No rooms were made for you.
Hey, you're all right, man.
For those who never quit, the battery that never quits. Energizer. Keep going.
So we are back for the final 15 minutes of play, and it's an 8-point lead by the Beavers of Oregon State. Attendance tonight, 91,828.
You think they took off those 10 students?
They're probably on that list right there. They're here in their heart, not their body. Right, the tailback. Pass to the tight end. First time they've gone back to the tight end in a while. And Joe Newton makes the catch. So a reminder, a program note, it is just hand to Notre Dame, and BYU are kicking off right now. As soon as we conclude here, that ball game will be shifted over to ESPN. So if you're looking for it here, go to ESPN2. This running play is going to go short yardage to around the 35-yard line. Well, Mike, here's an interesting note. How long it has been since Oregon State pulled off a victory like it would be huge here tonight? They haven't beaten a top three ranked team since 67, number one SC and number two Purdue.
Yeah, but Mike Riley knows he's got a program that's getting better and better out there. Dennis Erickson recruited very well to Oregon State. Mike Riley's the kind of guy that's going to sit in that program. He's going to be there for a long time.
But they're about to
build it.
About to increase the size of the stadium by 8,000 seats. As Anderson throws across the middle, and that one's nowhere close. Joe Newton, I assume the intended receiver.
Ron, go back to those two extra points. Big. When he hit the crossbar.
Yeah, those two and an interception that he threw back
when
in the first half.
That
when they were going in. And at least for 3 points. Crowd comes to life. Third down. They need to take it down to the 27-yard line. LSU showing blitz coming up tight at the line of scrimmage. Here they come. Anderson right over the middle has it complete. And it's not going to be enough for the first down. George Gillette on the receiving end. Now with the kicking woes they've had tonight, Mike, do you go for the short yardage thing or do you kick the field goal?
Good question. I'm going to let Mike Riley make that choice. I think you go for it.
It looks like that's exactly what they're going to do. Looks like Newton and Haynes will come to the ball game, the two big tight ends.
LSU makes her substitutions. Extra defensive lineman.
Crowd on their feet. Fourth down and a little more than one. And somebody moved on the offensive line. The defensive lineman almost encroached. He got back, and then the offense moved.
Dead ball. Ball start, number 74.
Jason Fadu. Whew. Now this may change the call.
Six.
Does change the call.
But now, Mike, he's still not sending in. Of course, they're a long way here. This would be a 50-yard attempt. Remember, they got to take it down to the 27-yard line. Here comes the crowd again. Gets the pass away, and it's incomplete. Corey Webster had the cover. And again, Kyle Williams with some really good pressure inside.
Corey Webster, who missed a tackle in a key drive, is all over my cast. Ball thrown behind. Saban knows that his football team now has given the offense pretty good field position they would have been if you punt the football.
And it should have given a mental lift the way that defense has played here in the second half. Justin Vincent, they pitch it back to him. Tries to cut it back, and as he comes back into traffic, that is a nice defensive play by Davidson. Kevin Davidson, a senior of the Tuscumbia, Alabama.
Ron, the reason the run is tough to do is because these two corners right here, Williams and Bronner, can shut down wide receivers that allow the other nine defensive players to play the run on the inside. When you have two corners that can lock down on the outside, well, you can do a lot of things defensively.
Marcus Russell, off balance, still throws the pass complete. And it's Vincent And he is stopped just across the 35, so it's going to be third down LSU. They need to take it out to the 43-yard line. And Trent Bray was still another tackle. We will check on the number of tackles that he has, but Bray has been truly outstanding tonight. Well, tonight's key stat is brought to you by Burger King, having their way. Defense has held LSU 2 of 12 on third down conversions this evening.
And this one might be the most important right here.
Yeah, you're right. With 11-15.
2 and 13.
Talked about Bray. He's got 9 tackles tonight. Russell standing tall in the pocket. Ball is incomplete. Pretty good hit right there on Joe Adai, and he finally gets up. Took a pretty good shot.
They hit you. The Beavers defense are gnawing on LSU's players.
Eric Anderson, the redshirt freshman out of Phoenix, is the guy who came up with that big hit.
Beavers, they can chew, right? They chew through the wood. They're chewing through LSU's receivers.
Remember this, LSU only gave up 17 touchdowns in 13 ball games last year. They've given up 2 here tonight. Here's the kick. Driving Spiral, far and away the best one tonight. Spiral will turn over at the 18. Bernard gets by 1 and does not get by 2 and 3. Stopped at the 25-yard line, so we'll take a timeout. 15-7, Oregon State continues to lead.
That is sweet.
My pride and joy.
It looks new.
Like right out of the showroom.
Oh, that is one great looking...
Whoa, hold on, honey. I'm showing Tom the floor.
Nice floor, Joan.
Make your garage floor the envy of the neighborhood. You can do it yourself with Rust-Oleum Epoxy Shield Garage Floor Coating. After prep, you're ready to go. Simple as painting a wall. Easy to clean and resists chipping and peeling. This all-inclusive kit is available at home centers, hardware stores, and automotive retailers near you. And now, transform your unfinished basement with Epoxy Shield Basement Floor Coating.
Honey, 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 try this.
Malibu, with an available factory-installed remote start. Chevy Malibu, an American revolution.
Sorry about that. You all right?
Yeah.
An accident isn't your best moment. But at State Farm, we'd like to think it's ours. In fact, according to J.D. Power & Associates, customers rated us higher than any other insurance company for collision repair satisfaction.
Yeah, everything's fine. I talked to State Farm.
We know this isn't your best moment, but it's a moment you'll be glad you have a State Farm agent. So call us today.
Welcome back to College Football Saturday Primetime, 15-7. Oregon State, a huge underdog in this ballgame, and right now they're looking at 11 minutes and 26 seconds they need to get off the clock and also take care of the football on offense. Anderson, play action. Now under pressure, throws this one way downfield and way out of bounds.
Ron, you talk about the significance of this football game. We saw USC last week. They came back in the second half. LSU on the ropes at this point in the football game. So the number 3 spot is shaky.
You are right. We'll see if the defense can come up big again. They did on the last series. Second down and 10. Running play, breaks one tackle, falls forward for maybe a yard, and it's going to be third down and long, Oregon State.
The problem with the Beaver offense is they're not able to run the ball at will, and they have to take time off this clock. So when every time you throw and you get an incomplete pass, it stops that clock. But that's their game. Their game is throwing the football. With number 14, Derek Anderson, the key.
Here we go, third down. Need to 35.5-yard line. Packers showing blitz, and here they come off the right side. Anderson steps up, going to be sacked.
Wisely, because he didn't try to force the football. LSU coming with a blitz. Lionel Turner, number 58, gets blocked, comes off the block, makes the hit on Derek Anderson.
Turner and Landry combining on the stop, and here comes the punt. Molescu standing back at the 10-yard line.
Special teams, I think they're short one man on Oregon State's punt team.
About Cade's frozen custard.
Wow, this custard is creamier than ice cream.
We just thought Grandma's ice cream was good, but Cade's frozen custard is much better.
Frozen custard is similar to ice cream, only much better. It uses higher quality ingredients for a smooth and creamy taste. For a uniquely old-fashioned fresh taste, try Cade's frozen custard at the only custard stand in South Louisiana in Gonzales on West Corner View.
We're Dylan at the Plessis Pontiac Buick GMC in Gonzales.
Get a new GMC Envoy loaded, $20,880.
A new GMC Envoy XL, $9,500 off.
A new GMC Crew Cab, $9,500 off.
A new GMC Yukon, only $25,980.
A new Denali XL, $13,000 off.
A new GMC Yukon XL, $16,000 off. Remember, DuPlessis in Gonzales is where the deals are.
DuPlessis Pontiac Buick GMC in Gonzales.
Memory upgrade. Easy as Dell. Dell PCs use Intel Celeron processors.
No.
Yes, I'd like to redeem my credit card miles. Flight to Denver.
No.
LA?
No.
Fresno?
Where?
Fresno?
I'll fly out Wednesday.
That's gonna be a no.
Thursday?
All blacked out.
I'll take the red eye.
No. How about Friday?
Sure.
No.
Go from no to no hassle with Capital One No Hassle Rewards. Fly any airline, anytime, with no blackout dates. Check your mailbox for details.
I'm calling Capital One.
No!
Oh, no.
Hey, what's in your wallet?
ESPN's College Football Saturday Primetime is presented by Rust-Oleum Epoxy Shield for the ultimate garage floor. And in part by the new Chevrolets, 10 new cars and trucks in 20 months, an American revolution.
So we are back. The LSU Tigers started off very, very lethargically in the first half. In fact, at the end of the first 15 minutes, they only had 37 total yards. Right now, they're sitting at 168 on the evening, Oregon State 282. Jamarcus Russell back in the pocket. Rips it over the middle. Boy, he had him open and threw it behind Bo. Reese Davis, let's check back with you.
Okay, Ron, and we'll first take a peek at Toledo and Minnesota. 14-7, Gophers on top. This is their new quarterback, Ryan Cupido, finding Ernie Wheelwright. That's right in his wheelhouse. Wheelwright takes it in. Gophers on top, 21-7. They're still in the first quarter. Notre Dame and BYU, the Cougars just went into the end zone seconds ago. That game's on ESPN2 right now. We'll bring it to ESPN as soon as you guys are done.
Okay, Reese, thanks very much. Our situation, 15-7, Oregon State on top. Second down, they go with a run, and it's Ali Broussard who will be stopped after a gain of a couple. Hit by Swigert.
The comparison to the quarterbacks, Marcus Randall started off cold, 5-15. Jamarcus Russell, 6-17, but led his team to the one score.
Yep.
Tonight.
Ben Siegert on that last tackle. Mispronounced his name, I apologize. Sophomore out of Glendale, Arizona. LSU third down conversions, only 2 of 13. Right here, they need to take it to the 36-yard line. Russell steps up. He lost the handle on the ball. I believe it's been recovered by Oregon State. They'll say incomplete forward pass.
Well, that tail looked like it slipped out.
Yep.
Of his hands before he threw the football, before he showed bad snap. See the movement?
I don't think anybody hit it, did he?
Yeah. No, he just slipped out of his hand. I don't think that was a pass. I think that was a fumble.
Chris Jackson with his seventh punt of the night. High pass went over his head. Boy, has the composure to get it off, and Paul did is juggled down to the 17-yard line. Whoa, this has not been a great night for special teams, has
that,
it?
That Mike Riley's going to look at that fumble and say, that cost us a lot of field position yardage.
So 26 yards of the punt. We'll take a timeout. 8:34 remaining.
Last year, one man's dream became a reality.
Mike Hall, you are the dream job winner.
The dream remains.
We're trying to shock the world.
Shock the title.
The dream job.
Welcome to the big show.
But this year, the stakes are higher and the competition is tougher.
I lost it.
I need the energy high.
Let's get it up and running.
What does it take to win the job of a lifetime and earn the best seat in sports?
Dream job!
An all-new season of ESPN's Dream Job premieres Tuesday, September 14th at 7. Dream on.
Did you fill up the tank?
The new Silverado half-ton crew has more standard horsepower, more torque, and more towing capacity than Ford or Dodge.
This never happened.
Chevy Silverado, an American revolution.
So, we are back, just over 8.5 minutes remaining in our ball game. Even Batman is up and involved in this one. 8-point margin by the Beavers of Oregon State. Not much of the running play. As a Brian West comes over defensively to make the tackle. And Mike, you're right. There, I don't know if Anderson did injure his hand at halftime or what, but there has been a reluctance, or they have stayed away from throwing the football nearly as much as they did in the first half.
The other thing they're trying to do, Ron, is make this clock disappear. And they're not a running football team. Now, last year, Steven Jackson would have come back for his senior year. They could have done that.
Mike also wants you to comment on the fact where the tight end is lined up in the slot. They sent him on a pattern this time, but they've been using that as a blocker. George Gillette makes the reception right there. We'll talk about it more in a moment. Let's go back to Reese Davis. Reese.
Okay, Ron, I told you a moment ago that BYU had just scored. As I was updating some scores, this is how they did it. Na'ufahu Tahi going in for the Cougars, and Notre Dame is down by 7. Game's on ESPN2. We'll switch it over here when you guys are done.
Now, I understand why he doesn't have his name on the back of his uniform. Not that much thread in Provo.
Sell his LSU defense the second half has played their heart out, except for one drive where they missed a lot of tackles.
So Anderson calls a timeout, but the clock run way down. We have 7:13 remaining in the ballgame. Now, Mike, I'm kind of catching you off guard here, but I want to ask you a question that seems to keep sticking out in my mind of what they have done on running plays. I'm speaking of Oregon State with the tight end standing him up in the slot, and they've changed their blocking on that. They've done a nice job of doing a better job of confusing LSU and also keeping outside contained from coming in.
Done a good job with two tight ends on the on one side, stretching the defense, giving them one more gap to defend. So they've done a good job of scouting LSU over the winter time when they made this game, in the spring and summertime. They got a pretty good beat on this defense.
You know, a lot of people might have said, there's a country and western song called "What Was I Thinking?" And it may be the head coach at Oregon State might be humming a few bars of that, but I'll tell you what, right now, he's looking at 7 minutes and 13 seconds to get off the clock. He's got an 8-point lead, and I'll tell you what, he's not going to be asking "What Was I Thinking?" if he holds on to this one. What an upset this would be.
I'll tell you what he's thinking right now. He's thinking about his punter, because LSU's almost blocked the punts, the last two punts. So if they don't pick up this first down here, they've got to punt the football. LSU will come after him.
Crowd will let you know. Third down, they need to take it to the 28. It's Landry coming on the blitz right up the middle. Anderson is sacked at the 11-yard line. Fourth time that they've gotten to him, and it's Lionel Turner.
Second leading tackler on this football team last year. Comes through, number 58, on the outside. Just not enough people to pick him up. Ron, this is you got to hold your heart on this play if you're a Oregon State Beaver.
Pulescu, you can see where he's standing, about 2 yards deep in his own end zone. Here comes LSU. They're after him, and he gets the kick away. Nice job. Hanging spiral, not real long, but he got it off and away from the return man, and he's going to wind up really in very good position with a 43-yard boot.
That was big. Well, it's in the hands of the redshirt freshman, Jamarcus Russell, to hit some passes, because they're having a difficult time running the football.
See the touchdown drive, 79 yards. Other five drives, no yards. That's LSU this half.
These two corners, I've talked about them all night, Browner and Williams. They have shut down these outside receivers.
Justin Vincent. They send him back inside, behind a blocker, has 5, 6, maybe 7, let's call it 6. Trying to cross him up and also bring him back a little closer to a base defense.
Yeah, spread them out to run, reduce their front, and make them get some men in coverage so you can run the football. Keep your eye on number 90, Bill Swancutt. Andrew Whitworth, number 76, the offensive tackle, will be doing just that.
Vincent's got 47 yards, Mike, on 14 carries. Gets it again. Hit hard at the line of scrimmage. He's not going to have it now. And they're going to have a third down about a yard and a half. Siegert steps up into the pocket to make a tackle.
Nick Saban, at this point, is thinking two downs to pick up this first down. The two runs. I believe they'll still run this football here, try to pick up the first down.
Wood clock is really running away now. 5 minutes and 20 seconds left.
Oregon State's offense tonight, 180 yards, average 288 yards in 2003.
They got the first down as he takes it off the right side. That's Joseph Adai on the carry. That'll stop the clock for a moment at the 5:01 mark. Seekert again with another tackle.
Trying to help the redshirt freshman quarterback with the running game. You have a veteran offensive line led by Ben Wilkerson, the center. You turn over the football game to that line.
Early Doucette comes out to the right side. Keep an eye on him, the big freshman out of St. Martinville. Play action. Here comes pressure. Russell runs away from it. Now throws the ball. It is too tall. Boy, if he gets that down, as Siegert was the man coming with the pressure. He gets that down. Skyler Green still had position on the defensive back.
Shows you what an athlete Jamarcus Russell is. Feels the pressure from the backside, sprints out under control, and throws the ball just a little bit high. Using on coverage, number five.
Yeah, Siegert had offseason shoulder surgery. And boy, he's not playing like it here in this fourth quarter. He has really been tough. Russell gets it out there, has it complete. That's enough for the first down to Bo. And he'll stop the clock at the 4.5 minute mark. It's a gain of 14, and nobody is leaving the stadium.
Easy throw for Jamarcus Russell. Hitting Dwayne Bo on a flat route. He's working against a defensive back. Keith Ellison, the linebacker. When you don't play a nickel defense, Ron, you're sitting in there with linebackers against receivers, and they're working on Ellison.
Play action. Look back to his right. Now asking for somebody to help out, and he will fight his way forward to the 26-yard line. He gained about a yard and a half, maybe two. Pollard was there to stop him.
Pollard is an outstanding linebacker. Go back to the two missed extra points, become very big. Jamarcus Russell down. Cramp?
I tell you, it does look like it, yeah.
As he tried to get away from the rush.
See, and then it came across the back of his legs, and this is when he tries to get up, and it's like that's when the cramp really jumped on him, and he tries to stretch out and touch his toes right there.
Ron, Marcus Randall's going to come back into the football game.
Has to come in for a play. He sure does. Let's go to Reese Davis and check with him. Reese?
Okay, Ron, while you guys are waiting there for a second, I tend to Jamarcus Russell a few scores. Texas has rolled up over 600 yards of offense. Zelvin Young's over 100 yards, likewise for Cedric Benson. Neither of them can touch what K.J. Harris did for West Virginia against East Carolina. A Big East record, 337 yards on the night. That breaks Edgerrin James' old mark of 299. Missouri and Arkansas State, Mizzou rolling big. Troy goes into Huntington and beats Marshall. You'll be able to see the Trojans of Troy against Missouri Thursday night on ESPN.
So there's Jack Marucci, the trainer, who's standing there talking to Coach Saban, explaining to him the extent of the injury, or if it is, in fact, just cramps. And I say just cramps, that can put him on the shelf for the remainder of this one. Joe Adai is in the backfield. Randall, boy, and they are going to get a delay of game penalty.
Well, when you stand over in the sidelines and not involved in the football game, and you come out there, pick up a delay of game penalty, and Nick Saban's talking about the clock. He thought the clock was set too fast. Checking with the referee.
Second down, 14.
Well, Anderson on the far sideline trying to keep his teammates up. Right now, they're 3 minutes and 38 seconds from pulling off a gigantic upset. Randall sets in the pocket, gets his pass off, underthrown, and he caught it. A dive. How many times have you seen it when a ball is underthrown? The defensive backs run past the guy. catches the ball as they're trying to continue their cover.
Ron, I want to go back to Adai. Comes out of the backfield against the linebacker, Trent Bray, number 44. And you're right, Adai does a good job of coming back. But what I want to talk about is Marcus Randle. He came off the bench after being benched and makes a big-time throw.
Inside the 10-yard line, first and goal, LSU Tigers. Randle rolls the pocket. He's got a man there. Didn't get it off. He'll run it to the 5-yard line and then step out of bounds. Bray was the man who was applying pressure, but I'll tell you, if he throws it from the get-go, Bo is open in the flat.
This defense of Oregon State has played so well tonight, but their back is in the inside the 6-yard line. They have to come up with a play.
Ninth play of the drive coming up here. Second down and goal. Can't take a sack in this position. Right up in the middle, too tall, incomplete. And the receiver is down. Early Doucette is down about 4 yards deep in the end zone.
Early Doucette going to come inside. Gets bumped a little bit. Never gets inside. Oregon State defensive backs and linebackers did a good job of roughing him up on the pattern.
Now it's third down.
Maybe some kind of rollout where you get Marcus rolling out here to the left side.
Marcus Randle, and they get it back in the middle. A dive down to the 3, down to the 2. Tackled by Jonathan Pollard. With a shovel pass, bringing it back inside. I wouldn't want to make this call right here, Mike.
Well, you got to go in for the touchdown, but you still got 2:53 and 2 timeouts. So you still could get the ball back if you don't score right here.
So we're going to take a break. 2:53 left in our ball game. Oregon State 15, LSU 7.
It puts pause control right at your fingertips. It'll help you with those important tasks. Or not. Moon. Buy it for looks, buy it for life.
Shot espresso drink. Bring on the day.
I'm going to tell you this one more time. I've never bet on baseball.
One of the game's greatest players has engaged in a variety of acts which have stained the game.
It's so against the rules, it's not even...
Oh, the hell with the rules. You know I can't watch a game unless I got something riding on it.
You're going to phone Pete's picks into me. I'm going to then relay that action to New York.
And he now must live with the consequences of those acts.
You sure you want to do this?
Just place the bets, Paul. Come on.
No player, no matter how exalted, is above the game.
Only a Moen faucet puts pause control right at your fingertips. It'll help you with those important tasks. Or not. Moen. Buy it for looks, buy it for life.
And we're back, and you're looking at number 4, Jamarcus Russell, the redshirt freshman out of Mobile. Cramps and all, he's off the bench, and he's in here for this fourth down play.
Ron, this is Skylar Green right here. Some kind of pick play where you get him open. Motion.
Roll the pocket to the left. Looking, still looking. He's got a man there. Lofts it in the end zone and he overthrew him. Oh, he had Skylar Green and he tried to put a touch on it and he touched it too far.
Well, he knows. Nobody has to tell him. He tried to basketball shoot it to Skylar Green. Skylar Green was open from the start of that play. He went in motion. They picked for him. He was open in the flat. They didn't get the ball to him. Still a chance. LSU. Just tried to push the ball and it got away from him. Wide, wide open. Still got a chance with two timeouts and 2:47 on the clock. Mike Riley seen everything on the sideline tonight.
Now he looks up at that clock and he said, "Now I've got to get 2:47 off there."
Off there.
It's been an eternity here in the fourth quarter as Green is being helped off the field.
Jamarcus knows the mistake he made. You're seeing the evolution of the quarterback tonight because he's done some good things. Just needs playing time to get ready. This is where you hope your offensive line, if you're the Beavers, that you can get a couple first downs running the football.
LSU crowds at line of scrimmage. They go straight ahead with the run and maybe a yard, and that will be it.
Number three in the team in the nation in trouble with 2:40 on the clock. Ron, you talked about, we talked to Nick Saban about, and the players about the national championship. They said that Nick Saban talked to him all preseason camp. Put your rings away. That's last year. That's history. You're 0-0 when you start the season this year.
Well, we still got 2:40 showing on that clock. This is a defense that has been relentless.
I'm impressed with the defense in the second half, except for one drive for LSU. Will Muschamp, the defensive coordinator, one of the best young defensive coaches in the country, has set us defense up tonight that put pressure on the quarterback, Derek Anderson, here in the second half.
So, Mike, we're just double-checking here. Only one timeout remaining for Oregon State. And it is a second down. They gave him about a half-yard gain on the play. And this running play will take it out across the five to the six. Lionel Turner there to make the tackle.
All you want to get is you want to get the first down. But if you can't get the first down, give your punter a chance. A little bit more yardage.
So let's step aside for a quick break. 2:29 remaining. 8-point lead for the Beavers.
He's put a lot of preparation into this moment. He sets up. Oh, he didn't see that one coming. But wait, he won't be denied. He's going for it. He may have it. Oh, let's see that again. Ooh, that's gotta hurt. He worked hard for that victory. Campus Federal, putting things within your reach. It's new. Everyone is talking about Cade's Frozen Custard.
Wow, this custard is creamier than ice cream.
We just thought Grandma's ice cream was good, but Cade's Frozen Custard is much better.
Frozen custard is similar to ice cream, only much better. It uses higher quality ingredients for a smooth and creamy taste. For a uniquely old-fashioned fresh taste, try Cade's Frozen Custard at the only custard stand in South Louisiana in Gonzales on West Corner View.
About Flonase.
And we're back, and to reiterate, the number three slot right now in jeopardy. Number one and number two have won. Number four has already been victorious. Third down. Here comes the blitz right at the middle. The ball is caught, but he's not going to have the first down at the 10.5-yard line.
Safe route, Ron, but the main coverage was so tight on the route, they didn't have enough yardage for the first down. Now if you're again, Mike Riley, got to get this punt away.
LSU has been oh so close. And let's see if they come after him again. Mike, would you have the return on?
No, they got 11-man rush.
Yes,
they're coming after it.
They don't even have a deep man on the field.
They're coming after it.
Got it away. And it's a good spiral. Got a turnover. It takes an Oregon State bounce. All the way down to the 30-yard line, 35, I beg your pardon. And boy, put an asterisk by that play right there. That is a 54-yard boot.
That was a great snap and a great punt.
Well, the last time a national champion lost its season opener, that was Michigan, lost to Notre Dame in 1998. Tigers still have a minute 38 seconds, though. Jamarcus Russell, the redshirt freshman, continues to guide the team. Pressure up the middle. This pass is almost intercepted. Piscatelli almost came up with the pick as he kind of loped it out there to early Doucette.
Jamarcus throws off his back foot on this play. Tries to hit Doucette. Could have been picked off. Anderson's right in this play. He's playing defense. The crowd, 5,000 people came from Oregon. They got Bob Uecker seats up there. They're high.
Yeah, they are. They're going to be even higher if they pull off this victory. 1:33 remaining. Gets this pass out. And that one a little too high for Justin Vinson. And now it's going to be third down.
Ron, if he completes that pass, Vinson had some running room. Not going to go all the way, but going to stop the clock with a first down. Skylar Green injured on that throw where he basketball shot it to the end zone. He's not back in.
LSU, they've missed their last five third down conversions. And in fact, on third downs tonight, they are 2 of 16. Here it comes, third down. Gets this one wide open over the middle. It's Bow. Gets by a tackler, heads for the sideline, and he's down inside the 40-yard line.
Had to be a busted coverage because Bow was wide open in the middle of the football field.
There's still a minute 20 seconds on the clock for people who started heading for the parking lot. They better come on back. This one's not over by a long shot. Jamarcus Russell sets to throw. Over the middle, got his man, and it's Bow again. 10!
Jamarcus Russell with a big time throw and a big time spot.
See that sideline looking it over. 2-point conversion coming, trying to tie it at 15. 105 left. Russell steps up. He's going to run it. He's got it. We're tied. Thank you.
big. Jamarcus Russell, there is a new sheriff in town in Baton Rouge. Wide open right here in the middle. Bo was freed coming in on this slant route. Eric Williams got behind him, couldn't catch up with him, pulled up. Two-point play. Jamarcus Russell goes back to pass, sprints out to the right. Good vision, good athlete. He knows he can make it to the end zone. Gets in there for the tie.
And people forget, you look at his monstrous size, which is 6'5 and close to 250. But the young man can run extremely well. And he proved it right there. So Jackson will kick it off. We have 65 seconds left in this football game.
People in Mobile, Alabama are watching this game proud of Jamarcus Russell.
Look at this kickoff. Well, he almost brought that thing back out.
Go back, Ron, to the two missed extra points where they hit the bar. Become big.
Now, I want to point out one other thing. One of the reasons that this one was missed is because Anthony Wheat Brown carried the ball to the sideline and got a 5-yard delay of game penalty, and I think they would have made that extra point. It was just that close.
Oregon State might just play for overtime. Here they got one timeout. May go with one throw deep down the field.
But LSU has no timeouts remaining.
That's what the crowd was talking about. They thought his foot was on the outside the line.
Yep, and they're going to keep it on the ground.
They're going to play for overtime. Headed to overtime.
Well, Ernie used to say, let's play two. This one seems more like three. Boy, for a first half that drug on, the second half has certainly had its share of drama.
Both teams a little tired going into this overtime.
Yep. Second down and eight. You see the game clock is at 25. Pass is caught by the tight end. Then Woo, a monster blow put on Newton by Quali. Well, I tell you, from the angle he hit him, he could have knocked that ball loose.
You like the team that just scored before they go to overtime. LSU seems to be on a high at this point.
Listen to this crowd. They're on their feet. 2 seconds, 1 second. We're heading to overtime in Baton Rouge. We take a timeout, and as we head to the overtime period, it is LSU 15 and Oregon State 15. Let's catch our breath.
Hey, Bobby, how do you get to the Chase?
You know where they race modifieds? Start there.
Then you'll go past a lot of trucks.
Okay.
What am I, your tour guide? Beat it.
Easy, Kevin. Want to take home the title? You gotta get to the Chase first. NASCAR 2005 Chase for the Cup. Rated E for everyone.
Just follow me.
EA Sports. To the game.
Somewhere, there's a man accessing sensitive information by way of a fingerprint, while a security team closely monitors the ship's cargo, helping to keep our port safer. And a dad checks on his business from his son's baseball game. What do all these people have in common? They rely on America's number one security company, ADT. Always there. You have headquarters in Seattle. Procurement in Denver. R&D in Dallas. And marketing in Miami. We can design, deliver, and manage your communications for all of them across platforms, across America. Consider the dots connected. SBC.
So we're back in Baton Rouge. Boy, a noisy stadium right now. Tied at 15, heading to overtime. And the rules are coin toss for choice of offense, defense, or end of the field. Each team gets one possession from opponent's 25-yard line per overtime until winner is decided. No game clock, play clock only. And a team must go for two-point conversion starting in the third overtime. And as tired as these two teams are, I hope we don't have to go to a third overtime.
The advantage LSU
What a ball game. Oregon State, almost a 20-point underdog coming into this thing. And they have never thought that they were an underdog at all, let alone by that margin.
A lot of missed opportunities for them.
Yeah.
Missed a field goal, the interception when they got inside the plus 30-yard line. Squandered away another scoring opportunity. Two missed extra points. They've let LSU get back in this football game.
And we should explain to some of those of you who said, well, hey, this ballgame started at 5 o'clock. Why has it taken so long? We had a delay of almost 50 minutes because of lightning and rain here in Baton Rouge. So almost an hour late getting started. And then a lot of passes were thrown in this football game. And that's the reason Central Time we're about to hit 9:25. You thought you'd be halfway home by now, didn't you?
No. I knew when that rain and lightning hit.
Now here they come out, about to have the flip of the coin.
Everybody wants to go on defense first. Something happened.
And of course, LSU said immediately, all right, if we're going to play defense, we're also going to put you with our student section. There it is right there.
No, they
okay,
they
so he missed call.
It, yeah.
I started to say, Mike, I haven't seen an overtime where a team won the toss and won on offense.
I thought that was going to be something new. They wanted to put confidence in their offense and make something happen. But when you have young quarterbacks, Jamarcus Russell, you want to force them to make a move first. Jamarcus is growing fast.
Well, his percentage is not great.
No.
But those nine completions, 145-yard are huge plays. Two touchdowns, no interceptions. And they'll open with Ali Broussard at tailback. Broussard gets it behind the block of his tight end, and he's going to be hit and knocked down for a loss. Yeah, Jones lined up at fullback that time. And Trent Bray from that middle linebacking spot is out there to make the stop.
This is one series where you got to ask your defense because they're so tired. You see Eric Williams, number 8. They're so worn out, both defenses, that they have to get one more time, 4 plays, get off the field, force a field goal to attempt, and hope your offense can win it.
So Lawson comes to the ball game at cornerback. From the shotgun, gets it out in the flat and has it to Benson. Turns it back inside. Wiggles his way down to the 21-yard line. It's going to be third down to LSU. They need to take it to the 15 for the first down.
Safe throw for Jamarcus Russell.
I guarantee you, Coach Saban down on the sideline is saying to himself, I've had enough of fourth down tonight, and I don't want to have to go through that again for the victory. So let's pick it up right here, fellas. First overtime period. Third down and six, LSU. Here's pressure, and he just throws this one up, and the ball is caught out of bounds. Doucette. And there's a flag down. So Henry Anderson with some big pressure on the play. LSU saying the penalty is against Oregon State.
SEC officials here making the call. See, hopefully we can. Big, big penalty. It's going to be called on Trent
holding on
Keith Ellison.
On the defense. The holding occurred before the pass. With the 10 yards, the line of gain is made. We have a first down.
Keith Ellison, number four, is going to get called for the hold. You're going to see it right there. He was holding on Doucette and got, it was a good call.
So the ball is down at the 12-yard line. Penalties tonight against Oregon State, a total of 10 for 65 yards. It looks like confusion on this play. Ought to just run it. He's going to throw it too tall and had Bowe open for the touchdown. Good heavens.
Ron, again, you're going to have young quarterbacks make mistakes. But that ball was snapped before Jamarcus Russell's ready. And now all of a sudden he breaks out. He's got a wide open Bowe and just throws the ball too high. He also could have run the football.
He could have run the football. You're right.
And maybe hit the end zone.
He had one man who was shadowing him underneath that might have been there to make the tackle.
Eric Williams, number eight, is out of gas. The corner for Oregon State.
Here we come with second down. Looking for the end zone for Doucette. Throws the ball, and it is knocked out of bounds wisely. Boy, a die again. Play defensive back, and we've got a marker down.
Another holding on Oregon State.
And the difficulty right here is Jamarcus, I think, is suffering from cramps again. But they're going to have to take him out of the ballgame again.
Receivers, Doucette again, number nine, that was being held right here. Maybe the call. The jersey pops out, so another good call. Brandon Browner, the corner. Ron, with Jamarcus Russell hurt coming out this play, I think you can almost guarantee this is going to be a run.
See Jack Marucci there with him. Jamarcus is very upset. He'd like to be in this ball game and be 100%.
Well. He's really played well tonight.
Allie Broussard lines up at tailback, number 22. He gets the handoff right side. Boy, he's met hard at the line of scrimmage. That's a nice job defensively by Jonathan Pollard, the senior out of Las Vegas.
Oregon State knew it was going to be a run, too. Pollard came off the corner and made that tackle. Marcus Randall, remember, he had a big pass in that last drive to get him down there.
So Broussard comes out. Justin Vincent checks into the lineup. Second down and goal. The ball at the 5.5-yard line. First overtime. We're tied at 15. LSU and Oregon State.
Quarter.